Company.com to find out about all of their services. Welcome to Jack Ryan Field here at Bishop Hartley High School, where tonight the Hartley Hawks are getting their 2023 season started against Big Walnut. I'm Bob McElligott alongside of Matt Barnes. And Matt, here we are back again here. And the Hartley Hawks, a very different looking football team than the last couple of years. They're going through that transition. It's kind of from one set of classmen. They start as freshmen. They move to the seniors. And it rolls over. This is a rollover phase.
Absolutely. And, you know, they have some positions that they are trying to replace as well as some newcomers that have a lot of college offers and a lot of promise and potential. But it all starts right here. If you want to have a kind of rebound season after what was a disappointing 2022 campaign, what a quality opponent in Big Walnut. And for Big Walnut, coming off a 10-win season, new coach. Let's see what they have as they begin their 2023 campaign.
Yeah, new coach, and hoping for the same old result, as you said, after having a good season. Bishop, or you look at Big Walnut, they've got the numbers, but Bishop Hartley, they always put a lot of pride in having the heart and getting the right people on these teams, and that's what they're looking to roll out there tonight.
Yeah, they've run the system under Brad Burchard for years, and they're a team that prides itself on being tough, even if they have smaller guys or a smaller roster. So it's all a matter of kind of proving the doubters wrong. And this is a game they're expected to possibly lose, maybe close, but you can't tell that to this Hawk team. They expect to win.
Absolutely not. Ready for the opening kickoff to get things started here for Hartley. They're going to get the football first. As you can see, we're Big Walnut. The Eagles getting ready to kick it off from the 40-yard line.
You know, it's the first game jitters for the score clock operator, too. We've got to remember how to reset it to 12 minutes here.
That's exactly what we're waiting
exactly
for, too. Matt
is
not kidding. We are waiting for that. And, yeah, there's always that first time out of the gate. And here we go. They have it set at 12 minutes, and the ball is teed up on the 40-yard line. There you get a look at that Hartley sideline. Is everybody set, ready to go? These players, these coaches have been working for weeks on end to get ready for this game here tonight to get things underway. And before we get them underway, we'll have yet another whistle before they kick it off.
Ah, yes, his knee pads were too high. Okay.
All right.
Well, we're off to a flying start.
Meticulous.
Very meticulous. Listen, it's the first game for the referees, too. They got to look good.
That's right. Ryan Elliott is ready to do the honors here and kick the ball away. Hartley with two men deep. And it is a big kick. And that will carry all the way to the back of the end zone. No need for Fidelis Amosia to try to run that back. Hartley will get the first to get the ball on offense for the first time here tonight. Ready to set it up right at the 20-yard line. Take a look at the offense. Matt Golich, the quarterback, sophomore quarterback that is going to run this group. And Matt, when you look at the running backs, they're always extremely important in this set.
Yeah, absolutely. You lose Deontay Hubbard, but you bring back a lot of experience in Robert Lathan, Roy Ralston. Joy Wooten's going to obviously listed a wide receiver, but he's going to get a lot of runs as well. This is a team that likes to run the ball. We'll probably do it 80 to 90% of the time, even with the new quarterback, especially maybe because it's his first start. Get him comfortable.
Send a man in motion and hand it off. It's an option. And here's a pass right down the middle of the field. And leaping up and hauling it in for a moment was Ryan Perry. It was knocked out of his hands, but we do have the flag. And pass interference against Big Walnut on the very first play of the year.
How about that call? Talk about Joey Wooten's going to have a chance to run the ball. You think that's what they're doing on a jet sweep. Instead, he gets the handoff, immediately heads back to pass. Ryan Perry had about 5 yards on him at that pass, a little underthrown. But, you know, sometimes the best underthrown balls are the ones that bring those flags. And 15-yard penalty, first down.
Well, the great thing about it is we talked about how they like to run the football. They're very conservative with the football. And the first thing they do is a trick play and try to catch them off balance. They did, as you said, a little bit underthrown, but they'll go ahead and they'll take the penalty, and then they get a pass interference call
on
goes both ways.
Wow. Now, I can't tell you the last time I've seen that word, pass interference on both guys. But, hey, like the play call because, you know, Big Walnut's been scouting that run or jet sweep the entire year. They're not scouting that one for the first play of the game.
Absolutely. Hartley set up in a much more traditional set right now. There is movement. And it looked like Hartley was able to draw them off sides. Trey Legg The defensive lineman moving first. That'll cost Big Walnut 5 yards.
Something watching these first games, the discipline of both teams. It's hard in that first game trying to get the nerves down. A lot of emotion, a lot of excitement. As you can see right there, Big Walnut quick to jump on that snap.
Look at Ryan Perry lined up on the wing. He comes in motion. And they will hand it off. And trying to go up the middle, breaking the first tackle and leaning forward for about three, Robert Lathan Jr.
Yeah, get used to a lot of that right there. Giving him the ball right up the gut, trusting that offensive line to push the pile. It was only first and five there, so a good chance for Hartley to get a first down here and get three plays here.
Take a look at that defense that is being put out there by Big Walnut. And they've got some, not just some big boys, but some senior leadership up front on that defensive line.
Yeah, senior leaders, and a lot of their guys don't have to go both ways, so they should be fresh every time they hit the field for defense.
So there's a second down, and Hartley sitting in a nice position here at second down and short. However, there's a whistle and a timeout for a delay of game and a 5 yard penalty. So there's the 5 yards a Big Walnut gave to Hartley. They gave it right back.
Yeah, again, it's the first game. So I think you're going to expect to see a lot of laundry on the field. Didn't expect to see this much in the first 47 seconds, but again, this is where the coach is good teaching moments very early in the game.
So second down and 8. And as they try to pitch the ball to the left again, there's movement. Illegal procedure against the Hawks. They'll back up 5 more yards.
Well, I don't think this is the start either coach wants. You want to get into a rhythm whether you're on offense or defense, and all these penalties aren't doing anything to help that. And obviously, if you're Hartley now, you're behind the sticks. You know, here you are with the new quarterback. You don't want to be second and 13.
But that's exactly where they are here. A long way to go. Now, again, they've already pulled, one trick play and throw the ball down the field. Who knows what gives here.
And a guy like Ryan Perry can go out, and they can get the ball to him. A little wind out here, but, man, he can really scoot.
They hand it off, and trying to bounce his way over the right side and really not getting anywhere is Bryson Winbush, the junior.
Yeah, he had a decent year last year as a sophomore, about 200-plus rush yards, but a good chance for him to be featured a little bit more with Deontay Hubbard having graduated. So expect him to be part of that running back rotation, picking up yards. But, boy, this is not where the Hawks want to be right now, third and very long. It's obviously a pass play, but with this Hartley team, never guaranteed that they're going to throw the ball on third and long.
Never guaranteed, but if you're going to do it, this is a good place to do it. So Let's see if they put it on the sophomore quarterback to try to pick up these 13 yards, at least get a good chunk of it here. Takes a snap, and he looks to the right. Perry's got it. Looking for some blockers, and he gets tackled from behind at about the 23, and that will leave him short of the first down.
Yeah, nice job by Big Walnut. They played deep there, made sure they protected that first down line, and obviously a little screen pass with wide receivers blocking. They surrounded him quickly for a short gain, and good defensive stop by the Eagles, but at the same time, the Hawks kind of shot themselves in the foot with those penalties there, taking him back.
Connor Bjornson coming out to punt the football for the first time. Brody Hatfield is the deep man, and he's standing at his own 40-yard line. High snap through the hands of Bjornson, and he has it knocked out of his hands. Big Walnut. Can they cover it in the end zone? It looks like Hartley got there first. There was a flag on the play as well through all of that.
I think that's just a beanbag they dropped for the fumble.
Okay.
But kudos to Joey Wooten for hustling back. Big Walnut had an easy opportunity to fall on that ball for touchdown. Only giving up 2 points there feels like an absolute win. Here's your replay. I mean, again, this is Bjornson's first time out there for the punt. And again, we talked about those nerves and all the excitement. It was a high snap, but one you hope he can grab. But after that, boy, you hope he can just fall down. But in the end, it ends up working. Because instead of getting him first and goal at the three, now it's only 2 points and you get him further down the field, hopefully.
Yeah, the safety has Big Walnut. Gets on the board, and Hartley, of course, will have to kick the football back to them once again. But you're right. Could have been much worse.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I think in the end, you kind of tell everyone, hey, let's take a deep breath. It's just been a very nervous start for Hartley on offense and even right there on special teams. Here's the chance to count again. Catch your breath. Let's get out there, put the defense, get a three and out, or at least a stop, and then recover and see what we can do from there. Because, yeah, a lot of excitement on that first drive that led to a lot of mistakes.
In hindsight, maybe you wish you were on defense first.
Seriously, yeah, I completely agree. Yeah,
and I just mean it's a little bit, yep, a little bit easier to run through it, right?
100%. Yeah, yeah. Defense always seems to play better in these first games. The offense hasn't caught up yet, and it kind of showed right there. And especially when you have a, you know, a quarterback that hasn't made a start yet against a really quality team like Big Walnut.
So Bjornsson will kick it away.
No snap needed here.
Drop kick. It'll be taken at about the 46. And Big Walnut's going to get to about the 46 of Bishop Hartley before it is all said and done. As running that one back was Eli Helton. And so Big Walnut comes to the field for the first time. And Jake Neer is the guy that leads the way here. He is the senior quarterback, 6 foot, 195 pounds. Of course, Nate Sievers back there is a senior running back as well. Again, experience on this offense.
Yeah, I was going to say, these are the two guys that are going to make this offense go. They lost some players from last year, but these guys, how about Jake Neer, 2,000-plus pass yards last year, and then Nate Siever, 2,000-plus rush yards. So this is who you're going to key on if you're Bishop Hartley. They lost some skill at the wide receiver position in terms of some seniors that graduated, but these are the ones you want to focus in on.
Neer in the shotgun. Not a great snap there, and he wants to run it. Having a hard time doing so. He's going to just get back to the line of scrimmage. But what did we just talk about? How the offenses seem to take a little bit more time. That first snap off the mark, and then absolutely no chance for him to get any blocking.
And what, they've had but 3-4 weeks of hard practice, few scrimmages to practice that first snap, and of course that happens in the first game. It's just one of those things that happens when you're, you know, 16, 17-year-old kid and all the excitement of a first game, all the nerves haven't completely gotten out. See if it calms down as the game goes on here.
So he did get back to the line of scrimmage, second down and 10. Neer's flanked by Garrett Stover, and he hands the ball off to him. Stover finds some room, and he's going to power his way past the first down marker. He gets just enough. He picks up 11 for the first down.
That's a big boy right there running the ball. 6'1", 210-pound running back. You think he should be playing tight end. And look at all that room around the right side. A nice cutback and easy first down yardage for Big Walnut there.
The Hartley defense. Linebackers are going to be a key. And here's a great job of getting in a defensive tackle. Malik Tufts, a junior, able to be the first one to the quarterback and haul him down to the backfield.
Completely blew up that play. Check out the replay here. Again, another not-so-great snap, and it doesn't help for that read option when you can barely get the ball into your hands, let alone into the other player's hand there as he was trying to get to Stover. So great job by Tufts breaking up that play, completely screwing up the timing.
Loss of three. So second down to 13. Hand the ball off. Sievers around the left side. And he is tripped up. Good job of making that tackle. Hartley just able to get a hand on him as he was going by. Xavier Martin Fuller, I believe, may have been the guy that got the hand on him.
Yeah, as you can see, Seaver's a little bit smaller back, a little quicker as well. So on those jet sweeps, you think you're going to see him running those a little bit more often. Nice job picking up half that yard. He's putting them in third and manageable here. And now if you're Hartley, again, they spread it out wide, Big Walnut. So now you have to be prepared. They're going to pass the ball, going to run the ball. Not exactly sure as you start this drive here.
Hand it off, Sievers with some room, and then he kind of caught a toe and fell down, and that helps out the Hartley Hawks because that will bring him down about 2 yards shy of the first down marker.
Yeah, you're right. The Hawks are lucky there to see him fall down because it seemed like he had another 5-10 yards ahead of him. That was another well-blocked play, and yeah, I don't know if he tripped on himself or tripped over a lineman, but lucky that they got the fourth down play here.
They've got it in the backfield once again. Garrett Stover, we've already seen one big run from him. They just need to get two to get the first down. He's a big man. And now he's going to shift to the left of the quarterback. Fake it to him. They'll throw it. Out to the right side. Sievers. He is hit. Tries to bounce away. And the Hartley defense holds strong.
Wow. What a play call. I'm very surprised by that. Fourth and two. You got a guy like Stover in the backfield who you think can get that 2 yards for easy. Instead, they pass the ball. And it's quickness of the Hawks on the outside. Watch right here. Who's that right there? That's number 8 for you. Denham Cook. Oh, man. He just completely blew that play up. Quarterback had to throw it behind Severs, and he can never get his footing back, and that completely messed up the timing. And just like that, Hawks get the defensive stop they need and get the offense back on the field.
A huge defensive stand for Bishop Hartley, who trails 2-0 in this game on their second offensive possession of the game now. And here's a handoff. And finding his way up the middle, breaking a tackle and getting over the 35 to the 36-yard line. A very nice job there and running the football. Aaron Shoemate carrying the ball that time, getting in there. And again, the shiftiness, the quickness and the shiftiness.
And that's the kind of play that Hartley's going to need to calm down a sophomore quarterback making his first start.
Here's a handoff, and Ralston bounces to the outside, trying to push his way to the 40-yard line, but he's got enough for the first down.
And just like that, that's the kind of Hartley offense that you want to see. Big one, this is what they prepared for, this kind of in the trenches kind of battle. You know, even if you give up 3 or 4 yards, you're not too mad about it, but when it's 2nd and 3, gets the first down, you're not too happy. But again, this is the kind of game I think we expected. Hartley drain that play clock a little and then run the ball just outside the tackle or inside.
Set up in a traditional I formation. Almost drew that defensive line off with a hard count right there. Plenty of time on that play clock. Collins takes a look. Sets up the offense, brings a man in motion. And they hand it off. And can they get to the corner? The answer is no, but it's not for a lack of trying. Great job there and trying to run that football. Bryson Winbush, and he just faced way too many Eagles of Big Walnut.
Yeah, great job by the Eagles stringing that play out. Really, really nice job by the linebackers there. Didn't fall for that at all. They kind of knew right when he was going to get that ball, and they were ready. I mean, check out the defense right there. That's a great job by Eli Helton, really stringing it out, grabbing that tackle.
Yeah, Helton was the one that made that play. Absolutely right. So it is now 2nd down and 10 as Winbush was able to get back to the line of scrimmage.
This is where if you're Hartley, want to get this third and manageable. Don't want to leave yourself 3rd and long once again.
Delayed handoff, and again, nothing doing. And there was just no room whatsoever as they handed it off. And the guy that blew that up was Cohen Lyles.
And listen, I'm not a very smart man, Bob, but when I see a 5'11", 266-pound defensive tackle in front of me, I'm going to fall down pretty quickly, too. I mean, he just swallowed that play up. I would do my best to run away from his direction.
So it's 3rd down and 9. As Aaron Shoemate picked up 1 yard on that run. Handed off to him again. Now the double handoff. And here come the Hawks trying to get up near the 50-yard line and breaking a tackle and able to do that, getting into Big Walnut territory. Bryson Winbush, 2nd and 3rd effort to get it done.
First off, I love the play call. You really see the double handoff, especially when it's going forward still. So that's impressive. But the second thing, the shiftiness of Winbush, I mean, that should have been a 7-yard gain, then short for the first down. But instead, Winbush with a nice cut inside and then outside. I mean, really, really nice job by him. I think Big Walnut wasn't prepared at all. Yeah, that's at least 2-3 missed tackles by the Eagles that they're going to really be mad about, because that should have been 4th down.
Well, by the time the second handoff was made, he was already by the pile.
Yeah, absolutely.
And then it became a one-on-one.
Yeah, exactly. And the blocking downfield was fantastic.
Quick handoff this time, Rory Ralston. He is wrapped up immediately, and there will be no gain on that play. There was just simply nowhere to go. As right over the football, Trey Legg was able to grab hold of it.
Yeah, what you're noticing, as Hartley tends to do on offense, a lot of motion on every snap. It's just a matter of how much do the Eagles recognize that motion. Do they fall forward, not fall forward? In this case, it was a run up the middle, and they were very content to stay right there and not get too tricked by all the movement pre-snap that the Hawks are going to do.
Here's a pitch to the near side. Shoemate. Looking for running room, and he finds a bit of it, getting down to the 36-yard line. Again, well, you give this guy a seam, and he makes great decisions.
Yeah, and he's a guy that's only a sophomore. I mean, this is not one that I think Big One has a lot of tape on. Don't know exactly what to expect from him, and he has looked very good early, doing a really nice job finding just enough space to get those feet moving, and he's picking up those two or three extra yards that you don't think he should be getting, but by doing that, puts the Hawks in a great third down situation.
Now they just line them up. Three running backs behind the quarterback. Which one gets it? It's Shoemate, and he sidesteps a block there, and then gets all the way inside the 30. Again, nice job. You just need one.
Yeah.
But he saw the opportunity to get about six.
And here's your thinking. You're thinking, you know, if you're Big Walnut, maybe Roy Walston gets the ball, a bigger dude, just to kind of push the pile, get 2 yards. Instead, they give it to the smaller back. They have five men right up front, and the Hawks offensive line has just enough to give Shoemate his space. And he looks like, from what we can see so far, he doesn't need much room to get positive yardage.
No, and the Hawks are just on a roll right now, running the football down the field. Different sets, different styles, but they're making it work right now. They're all the way down to the Big Walnut 30-yard line.
Very methodical, and if you've ever seen a Bishop Hartley offense, you know they can run down a clock, 8-9 minute drive sometimes, and that's what they're doing right here.
And I think Roy Ralston jumped a little bit early there. And that's going to be a 5-yard penalty.
Yeah, one step too early on that snap count. And again, with an offense that sometimes can only get 3-4 yards a pop, you don't want to be going back 5 yards. And boy, all the positive momentum that the offense had, you don't want to be doing that.
And that's the thing about this drive, is they have just been rolling, moving forward. You go back to that first drive, all over the place. Penalties, movement, and this one has been very clean up until right there.
Yeah, exactly. And this is, again, the perfect kind of drive to calm down the nerves of a quarterback that, you know, is making his first start. Big Walnut kind of on their back feet as they try to figure out this offense.
Going to hand it off. And trying to go over the left side, Shoemate. This time, they sniff it out. And the guy that was there first for Big Walnut to make that tackle was Matthew Von Allman.
Yeah, I mean, Shoemate just absolutely hit at the line of scrimmage, and he's kind of coming off the field limping there a little bit. Hopefully he's okay. Looks like just kind of tweaked an ankle there. But great job by Big Walnut there. Now you keep the Hawks to second and 15. And here's a look we haven't seen from Hartley yet, this four wide look. Let's see if this is going to be a throw or if this is going to be one of those short throws and blocks. A lot of different options they could do here.
It's going to be the short throw out to the right side. And they're going to get only to about the 32-yard line. Robert Latham Jr. looked up, and he was looking for some blockers, and there weren't any there.
That's unfortunate, because both Denham Cook and Bryson Wimbush missed their blocks, and all he saw were white jerseys in front of him, and that is not what you want to see when you're a wide receiver trying to go forward.
Well, the first quarter comes to an end, and it is 2-0 in favor of Big Walnut. Tonight's broadcast presented by Columbus Painting Company, a locally owned small business. Columbus Painting Company is your choice for high-quality interior and exterior painting. CPC also provides power washing, fence and deck staining, gutter clean out, drywall, and trim repair. Let them help you get your home looking fresh and ready for football watch parties this fall. Call 614-818-8028 for a free estimate, or visit cbuspaintingcompany.com to learn more about their services. 2-0. Big Walnut has the lead over Bishop Hartley after one quarter of play here in the season opener.
Today's broadcast is presented by Columbus Painting Company. Call us for a free estimate at 614-818-8028 or visit cbuspaintingcompany.com. By the Mortgage Captain. Need guidance on your home buying journey? Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331.
Second quarter. Ready to begin here at Bishop Hartley. The Hawks trail Big Walnut by the score of 2-0. Bob McElligott and Matt Barnes with you. Hartley on the move, but right now they're looking at a third down and 12 situation. Send a man in motion and fake a handoff. Golic rolling out to the left, throwing and throwing it short. The intended receiver was Bryson Wimbush.
Yeah, that's a tough one when you're rolling out to your left and then trying to throw if you're a right-handed quarterback. Gallup's got a pretty good arm. I've seen a bit of the highlights that he's posted on social media, or the Hartley football program has posted on social media, so he can make that throw. That's just a tough throw to do when you're on the run and you've got a man bearing down on you. But here again, third and 12, you're trying to pick up at least half that yardage to give yourself something manageable. Also, too far for a field goal here. Don't really want to punt, so Hawks with an early fourth down go-for-it call, something that Brad Birch was not, you know, afraid to do it any time, even if it is fourth and long.
Yeah, you look at it, if you were going to kick a field goal, it would be 49 yards. So, as you said, way too long, even with the wind at your back here. So the single setback, two receivers out to the left, and they're going to look that way and throw that way. And here's Perry, makes the catch. Can he break a tackle? And he just about got there. He's going to be down about a half yard shy of the sticks.
Yeah, that was a chance for Ryan Perry to make a man miss. They knew that pass was going to be short of the sticks, but just a really nice job by Big Walnut's defender to make sure he did not get that first down. I mean, really nice job there. That was Austin Kawasaki making that tackle out there. So really nice job by Big Walnut doing what they needed to do to make sure they get the ball back. But, again, positive momentum there for the Hartley offense. I think you're happy to see that. It's only a 2-0 game. Your defense gets back out there. They played well in that first drive. And you're leaving Big Walnut the ball just around the 20-yard line. So all in all, positive momentum, but really wish you weren't in those fourth and long situations.
Came off a great defensive stand and then had a good offensive series. Here's Severs trying to keep his balance, and he does until he gets to the 24-yard line. That's where he's brought down after the 4-yard gain.
Yeah, one thing I've already liked about Seaver is when he gets hit, he still falls forward, and that will matter when it comes to those second and short, third and short kind of runs. That should have been a 1-yard gain. He falls forward for the extra two, and again, you get that from a guy who's your senior leader, 2,000-yard back.
And now there's Hartley right in the backfield.
And, of course, as I say that, the next time he gets the ball, he can't go anywhere. That, again, that's a tribute to the Hartley defense. About two or three guys there just blowing up that offensive line. Boy, the center just got pushed back quickly. A lot of blue in there, completely making that one not happen. With a Donovan Davis, I think, really right in the middle of it.
Jack Kellogg, that center for Big Walnut, 5'10", 242 pounds.
Yeah. Yeah, not tall, but he's still a big man to push back.
Donovan Davis, 6'1", 275,
coming in
at him. Third down play, and there's pressure, and there's a sack. Denham Cook stayed with the quarterback and takes him down.
Listen, Denham Cook is going to be a menace all year long for this Hartley defense. They're the reason he has about a dozen offers, including from my alma mater, Ohio University. Look at him come around the edge. Here's a hint for Big Walnut. Block this man. He comes in with a free run. Quarterback Jake Neer has zero chance to get this ball away. He's just running for his life, and Denham Cook's a little faster than he is.
Yeah, Neer sees it immediately.
Yeah, he knew
you
it.
Can't miss that guy, right? I mean, the guy's 6'4". You see him coming.
Yeah. Yeah, great job by the Hartley defense, getting off the field in three downs. And, again, they should get good field position here. Now it looks like the wind may have shifted a little as Big Walnut may have to punt into the wind.
So Big Walnut will take the timeout with a 2-0 lead here with that safety they got back in the first quarter. Yamo Sports is proud to continue working with Bishop Hartley to produce these broadcasts this season. We also want to tell you about the Yamo Media app that's coming soon. Yamo's mission is to create a localized network that celebrates Central Ohio. And you can find all of that content on the new app. From live stream events and sports to original shows and podcasts, the Yamo Media app will be a centralized location for all of our content. Make sure you follow us on Twitter at Yamo Media and Instagram, Yamo Media 614. To stay plugged in to the latest information, catch highlights from tonight's game, and much more. Yamo Media, achieve more. Fourth down and 16. And back to take the kick is Winbush for the Hartley Hawks. Bryson stands just about at midfield.
Again, Big Walnut punting into a pretty good wind right now in their direction.
And a short kick. It is going to fall at the 41-yard line. And it's going to get downed at the 41-yard line. It kicked about 2 yards ahead and then right back.
Yep. And penalty flag here on the near side. It looks like, judging by the way Coach Burfield's yelling, this might just be one of those sideline warnings you see in pretty much every high school football game these days.
That's exactly what it is. So the ball, they're going to put it at the 40. Nose of the football at the 40-yard line. The Hartley Hawks, pretty nice job here in the early going. The first offensive drive of the game, a bit of a challenge. It came back with a great defensive stand, another good offensive series, and now the defense went back out there and did it again. So now it's time for that offense starting in Big Walnut territory to see if they can get some points.
Absolutely, yeah. They had a lot of positive momentum doing it all with the run game. The pass game never really got going, but the run game was getting good chunks of yards. Let's see if they can keep that going, especially Aaron Shoemate, who's not on the field now, But he was getting a lot of that yardage early.
Collins rolling to his left, and he wants to throw. Pulls it down. Now he flips it ahead, and that is caught. Winbush takes a hit, and he goes out of bounds. But, again, we see the quarterback rolling left and throwing that same way. Did a great job to check down.
And you can see the athleticism of it, too. He did a really nice job, first off, getting outside the pocket. Looked downfield first, looking for more yards with Perry. Then nice job with the check down, finding Winbush wide open there. Really nice job for a sophomore quarterback completing that pass right there. That's not easy, again, when you're going that direction, but it does a really nice job being patient, finding the guy.
Second down and one as he picks up nine on the play. Hand it off, and up the middle, Rory Ralston, and he's got the first down and more, powering his way inside the 25 to the 23.
Yeah, this is that balance that I think the Hawks want to see all year long if they can, that chance to pass the ball on first down, and then on second down, keep that option of being able to pass because you know you can run it on third down. In this case, they do decide to run, and Ralston with plenty of room, and as big as he is, he can barrel his way to 5-6 yards easily.
Talk about that size, 6 foot, 235 pounds senior. And the ball on the ground from the snap. Big Walnut saying that they have the football. No indication from the officials as of yet.
Well, I think the officials are discussing the, I was wondering first if even a fumble or just an illegal snap, but apparently the Hawks do recover it. That whole play looked weird because pretty much all of the Big Walnut defense moved and none of the Hartley offense did. Let's see if we can see anything on a replay here. Now there was a snap, but it was weird because there was a snap, but none of the Hartley offensive line moved.
Miscommunication between the quarterback. The center snapped the ball.
Yeah, absolutely.
On the wrong count.
Yeah, clearly. Yeah. The Eagles defense was ready to go, and the Hartley offensive line was not at all.
Hartley wants to take a timeout here, and they will get that communicated down to the field in time before the play is run. So, again, little things. You're going to get a lot of them here in the first week. I mean, you give away a down right there, right? You lose a yard in the process, but still, that's why they take this timeout. You want to get the right play in there now. You want to execute it the right way. You want to keep this drive going.
Especially in the position you're in right now, right? I mean, you are in scoring position here. You got a chance to really punch it in for six or getting close to field goal range to take the lead. It's only a 2-0 game, second quarter. Don't make the mistake where you take yourself out of any chance to get points because of a dumb turnover when you're not fully in sync. So smart timeout call. You saw Big Walnut do that earlier as well. Again, I just think with these first games, you're trying to kind of get all the jitters and all the early mistakes out of the way. It's a winnable game for both teams, obviously, right now. So don't do anything crazy here that jeopardizes your chances of that.
It is second down. As the Hawks come back to get set up offensively here. A Big Walnut defense being tested now as they get further and further backed up toward their goal line. Collins wants to look it over. He's got plenty of time to do so. Now with under 10 on the play clock, he'll take the football. Fakes a handoff. Now they're going to give it to the man trying to come around. That's Winbush. He's got some room. He creates some more. He's still on his feet. Winbush down to the 10-yard line. That's a first down.
I tell you, Bryson Winbush is going to be a fun player to watch all season long with moves like that. But can we give credit to Zach Parker here? Watch him pull out the guard here. He's looking for a man to block. Looking. Please, anyone, finds the man. And then Winbush is like, I'll follow you, big man. And then from there, he does the rest. It's just missing tackle after tackle are the Eagles' defense. But great job by Winbush, but even more so by Parker.
That was the best one right there where he just slammed the brakes on, and Jax Lawrence went right by.
That's where you and I tear an ACL.
Yeah, that's right. That was the old Top Gun flyby right there.
Exactly.
First down and 10. Just outside the 10-yard line. Gallich wants to throw, and he throws it toward the sideline, and they're going to call that a catch. Big Walnut doesn't like the call, but the call has been made. It's at the 10. It's only for a yard. But you know what? That's the difference between positive yardage and finding yourself back a few yards or an incomplete pass.
And what I like more, too, is that he threw that ball one where only his guy could catch it. If it's incomplete, it's incomplete. Two, didn't take the sack. Really smart job by Gallich there. That's a tough play because there's not much room there as you're coming to the near side. High school has those wide hashes, not like the NFL. So when he rolls to the right, there's only about 10 yards to really play with. Nice job finding a receiver and at least, again, not making the mistake of throwing an interception or getting the sack.
Good job by Joey Wooten to tiptoe the sideline, too. And now Lathan, all right, up the middle, and he is down to the five-yard line.
Yeah, really nice job by him there. I think he actually had more room than he thought when he made that juke. Could have just kept going straight. Pretty good gain, though, still. Signals the first down. He's about 3 yards short, but, you know, can't blame the guy for being excited. But all in all, good positive yardage for the Hawks. And, again, this is a Brad Burchard-like team. It may be 2-0, but you got to think we have two downs here to get the 4 yards, or five, obviously, to get the touchdown. Not even thinking field goal.
And Hartley is going to take another timeout. 7:39 remaining here in the first half, and the Hawks have burned two of the three timeouts. Well, if you need guidance on your home buying journey, you can contact Todd Utrip at Revolution Mortgage. Todd, also known as the Mortgage Captain, is a trusted advisor that will help you navigate the process and help you land your dream home. Call Todd at 614-618-3331. Revolution Mortgage, an equal housing opportunity lender.
You know, you don't love using timeouts in this situation, but then you have to remember, in these games like this, the first half timeouts don't need nearly as much as the second half timeout. So this is the time to use them. You are so close to punching it into pay dirt. Again, don't make that foolish mistake where all of a sudden you're going back 5 yards and you're forcing yourself into a field goal. You have a real good chance here of punching it in. So smart timeout there. Again, first half timeouts not nearly as penalizing as those second half ones if you're trying to close out a game or stay in a game.
Very tight formation here for the Hawks, as Wooten will shift to the far side of that formation. And they pitch it to Latham. He's looking to pick his way through. He's got a crowd. They're pushing him from behind, and he's in for the touchdown.
And the first touchdown of the year for the Hawks comes in very Hawk fashion, just that tough, hard-nosed running style. And who else than Rother Latham? I mean, he had no room. But he just followed his big men, and they just kept pushing that big walnut pile. That was a tight formation. I mean, you had everyone within about 5 yards of each other. And the Eagles knew what was going to come. They just couldn't stop it because the Hawks were just pushing those puppies forward. And Layton just following his men into the end zone. Great drive by the Hawks.
Quarterback right there with the shove.
How about
at
that?
The end.
Until they outlaw that in football, you might as well keep doing it.
Extra point at 10 by Bjorson. And that is up and good. And the Hartley Hawks have their first lead of the game with 7:33 remaining here in the opening half as they're up on Big Walnut 7-2.
And what a difference that a year makes. The last time these two teams played, it was 35-0 Big Walnut. Hawks got 7 points when the clock was already on that mandatory running clock as they have in high school football in Ohio. This time it's a 7-2 game. They have controlled the time of possession. The Big Walnut offense hasn't gotten anything really going. The only 2 points they got, of course, on that safety on the punt snap. That fell into the end zone. So, all in all, great start for the Hawks. Now, if you're Big Walnut, here's your chance to make that response. The offense has gotten some plays, but nothing consistently going. Maybe now they can calm down and get things going because they obviously have talent to do it.
Another look at that touchdown by Robert Latham Jr. Getting a little help from his teammates to get over that goal line and put Hartley on top. Yeah, I agree with you. I think if you're Big Walnut and you've got the veteran offense that this team has, you say, hey, there's 7.5 minutes left in this half. We got to start to show something here, okay? I mean, I know it's the first game of the year, but we're now down. We just let them have two big offensive drives. We got to do something as well.
Absolutely.
Oh, and the ball is taken just inside the 30-yard line. And one of those patented Hartley, not a squib kick, but they like to kick it short. Evan Hart got it, and he got hit immediately.
Yeah, and I mean, lucky that this ball stayed in bounds, too. It kind of checked up nicely for the Hawks in terms of if it doesn't, they're going to get the ball, Big Walnut, much further up.
If he lets that go.
It might have crawled out of bounds. Yeah, but you can't take that chance when the Hawks are barreling down and possibly recovered for possession of their own.
So here they go from the 29-yard line talking about Big Walnut. And again, senior quarterback, Jake Neer. Now, he ran into some trouble on that last series with plenty of pressure coming from the Hawks.
Yeah, I mean, Denham Cook came around the edge that one time, and boy, he didn't know what to do. Here's the chance for, again, that offensive line. Take a breath. Figure out what they need to do to block this defensive line that's had their way with them pretty much in this first half. And, wow, another mistake. Again, we've seen plenty of flags in this game.
That was inevitable, quite frankly. And I say that because Evan Hart was lined up in the slot. And his quarterback is motioning for him to come. And to the point where it was like, hey, let's go. And the timing was just off on the entire play.
Yeah, again, this is all these early season mistakes you see in games like this. Yeah, you had a couple scrimmages, but it just means a little bit different when it's time at game time. And in these game situations, it's just been a little tougher for both these offense, frankly, in the early going to get in sync.
See, now they have Hart in the slot on the near side there at the bottom of the screen, number 21. They hand the ball off. Severs, he wants to get to that outside where there's room, and we've got some flags as the ball carrier is taken down at the 25.
Yeah, this was an easy call. I saw this with my own eyes right here. There's a reason why three of the referees threw their flags. That was Matthew Van Allman, the O-lineman. It looks like the right tackle, I think, is what he is. And he's coming off the field now, but he just dragged down the Hartley defender. Get a chance here to see it. Look on the right side here. Just completely pulls him down. It wasn't even Van Allman. That was actually Owen Pollock, the tight end. Not the right tackle, excuse me. But, yeah, Pollock just dragged him down. There's a reason why Severs was able to get any positive yardage, because the Hartley defender had no chance.
But, again, it goes to talk about that penetration they're
correct
getting.
Yeah, and that's why I think you saw the false start and why you're seeing this Big Walnut defense a little bit on their heels right now, and they can figure out how to slow down this Hartley speed off the edge. And I like what Hartley's doing. They're kind of moving Denham Cook both a little bit covering the tight end, so that way he can blitz that way. He can play defensive end. He's been at linebacker. He's kind of been all over the place. And you know the Big Walnut's focusing in on him because they know that's the guy you got to slow down if they're going to have any chance for offensive momentum.
We're going to have a timeout here. Is this an official timeout for spotting the football? For some reason, one of the officials was going to move the football about 3 yards ahead, but they put it right back where it was. Shotgun snap, pressure, and a throw. Incomplete. And again, why is that throw incomplete? It's because of the pressure coming straight up the middle by the Hartley Hawks. And it was Malik Tufts. He was one of those two guys that was going in there. Xavier Martin Fuller was the other guy.
Yeah, it's that ticking time clock you have when you're a quarterback. You know just how much time you have. You think you might have a little longer, and then you see Malik Tufts running at you. He had to get that ball away quickly, and Neer just couldn't find a way to complete that pass under that kind of pressure.
Second down now. Second down at 25, and here's Severs trying to find some room, and he's taken down at the 26-yard line. The first guy to get a hand on him there was Fidelis Somoja.
Yeah, and kudos to Big Walnut there. They're just trying to pick up some yardage to make this third down and somewhat manageable. Third and 25, he picks about half the yardage up. And Hartley kind of playing back a little bit, anticipating a pass. And Severs doing what he does as a senior, just finding a way to get that positive yardage, falling forward. But still, third and very long here. Hartley's got to be smart here. Don't let anything go over the top and avoid those penalties as well.
There's a snap and the pressure. They throw it back the other way. It is picked off and headed toward the goal line and in for the touchdown. Bishop Hartley, Brendan Lorette.
How about that? I mean, that is the kind of play that the Hartley defense is going to show on Saturday and tape and say, we got this, not because of what Brendan Lorette did, but what Denham Cook did. The pressure and then Lorette jumping the route. Oh, what a beautiful job. Cook getting the late block as well to make sure he controls into the end zone. That's just a great defensive stand by the Hawks. The pressure, then jumping the route, and then great hands for a big man on the D-line, because that's when you sometimes drop and you ruin yourself for the rest of the week. Not this time.
Huge defensive play for the Hartley Hawks, and they have a chance to add to the lead here with the extra point.
And nice job by the Hawks, too. That was first and very, very long. Not letting Big Walnut get any kind of offensive momentum. They were behind the sticks. They did everything they had to make sure they not only got off the field in the three and out, but then forced enough pressure to make them make a mistake.
There's a flag, and that is before the snap, and it's a procedure call. So they'll back it up 5 yards.
But, yeah, just a tough start for Big Walnut on offense here. I mean, this is the team that, again, put up 35 points in the last meeting. You know, a 10-win team that brought back, again, their senior quarterback, their senior running back. I think they're expecting to move the ball. I guess they know a very good Hartley team, Hartley defense. But they are really, really struggling moving the ball at all.
Bjornson with a line drive, and it's good. 14-2, the Hawks. Their offense has scored. Their defense has scored. And they're having a fine first half.
Yeah, they really are. I mean, 14-2. Hartley doing it with 7 points on offense, 7 points on defense, and frankly, the 2 points that they've given up came on their special teams. So Big Walnut, frankly, hasn't really been able to do anything with the ball at all. Just, I think, you couldn't ask for more dream start if you're Brad Burchfield after what was a very, very shaky first drive. It was rough to see, but ever since, and the offense has been clicking, the defense has really been hitting on all cylinders from the jump.
A minute and 6 seconds of game time came off that clock. When Big Walnut had the ball last time, 7:33 is what was on it.
That's right.
And I said they've got it. Their offense has got to get something going. It did, but yep. They still have time to try to find a little confidence going into the half. And that's what this Hartley defense has to make sure doesn't happen.
Yeah, and for Big Walnut, the big thing for them right now has been penalties. I mean, too many penalties that have put them behind the stakes or had them going backward. If they can stop that, they can maybe get some positive momentum.
Again, the squib kick down the far sideline, and this one does go out of bounds.
And again, this is the new kicker for Hartley, still trying to figure out those perfect spots and the way you want that ball to land so it kind of kicks inbounds, stays inbounds, finding those right angles. It's definitely a strategy that Hartley's going to employ all season long. They don't enjoy kicking it deep if need be. And every now and then you're able to recover one of those and get your offense right back on the field.
So again, the difference, the last one that stayed inbounds was back around the 19-20-yard line. This one gets placed at the 35-yard line because it does go out of bounds.
And again, in high school football at the 35-yard line, it's not the worst thing in the world. In the NFL and college, it's at the 40, so the extra 5 yards do matter. So it's worth taking a shot if you don't think your kicker can get it all the way down there.
Big Walnut, four receivers set. They're going to hand it off. And Seavers trying to cut back. He can cut back all he wants to, but there's no room there. And I'll tell you why, because Nick Ruby is there to make the tackle.
Yeah, nice job by Nick. And it looked like a gap there. Seavers absolutely made the right call. All the defenders were stacked up to the left side. He cuts to the right, but Ruby hadn't given up on the play. He finds Seavers and brings him down for a short gain. As again, Big Walnut trying to find that positive momentum to go into the half with some kind of points. But as of now, Seavers hasn't had that big chunk run that you know they would want to have to really get this offense moving. And now it looks like they're out of sync here, and they have to call a timeout.
5:52 remaining here in the first half. Bishop Hartley, they've scored offensively, they've scored defensively, and they have a 14-2 lead here in the second quarter over Big Walnut.
Today's broadcast is presented by Columbus Painting Company. Call us for a free estimate at 614-818-8028 or visit cbuspaintingcompany.com. By the Mortgage Captain. Need guidance on your home buying journey? Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331. By Yamo Media. Be on the lookout for the new Yamo Media app, soon to be available on the Android and Apple Store, as well as yamomedia.com. By Training ABC. Employee training courses that are simply better. Visit trainingabc.com for more information. And by PageTech. Take your event to the next level with PageTech Limited. Visit us at PageTechLTD.com.
Once again, Seavers takes the handoff, and once again, there is nowhere for him to go. Donovan Davis right there along with Joey Wooten to make that tackle.
Yeah, the Hartley defense is just gaining more and more confidence, and it's showing not just in the way they're tackling, but even in the emotion they're showing after that. They are fired up. I think they know they're in control of the trenches right now. And here you are, third and long, and they know they've been in control of this kind of down and distance as well because of the pressure they've been able to get on near. So now it's a matter of can Big Walnut stop the pressure and get a chance for the players to get down the field to get first down yardage.
Jake Near trying to roll. Now he has to cut back, puts the football away, and he is stopped at the 40-yard line.
Yeah, yet again, Denham Cook was in the backfield. He couldn't even look downfield any longer because he had to just put it in his chest and run. And when that happened, the Hartley linebackers were right there to catch him about 5 yards down the field. Again, another great defensive stand by the Hawks here. Just really, really well done to make sure Neer couldn't get that first down yardage once he decided to scramble.
Big Walnut lines up in the punt formation here. Winbush is not back deep this time. They sent Emoja back to about the 25-yard line.
I think if you're the Hawks, you're preparing for a fake just in case here, too. That's a nice position to do it if you're the Eagles to get some momentum, maybe.
Snap and a kick. End over end kick. Moja won't be able to field it, but it takes a Hartley bounce. And it'll be down near the 35-yard line.
Well, again, if you're Big Walnut, that was a drive you were really hoping to get down the field and kind of end this half on a positive note. Instead, your offense goes three and out, only gains 1 yard. And now your defense, which has been off the field for a little bit because the last time Hartley scored was on a defensive touchdown. But at the same time, they've had no answers for the Hartley offense the last two drives pretty much. They've had good long drives, only scoring on one of them. But can they slow them down this last 4:20 and possibly get their offense back on the field?
College brings a man in motion, takes a snap, hands it off to the first man through. A little quick handoff is going to be good for five or more. How about seven?
Yeah, I was with you. I thought five, and then those legs kept moving. That's going to be a seven-yard gain indeed. And just really impressive job of that Hartley offensive line. Again, Big Walnut's got some bigger dudes, it seems like, on the defensive line. They should be a little fresher because not a lot of them are going both ways. But watch the push. And not just the push by the guys in front, but the push by the guys in back. Really nice job there. That's Blake Wyatt pushing forward, pushing the running back forward to get those extra 2 yards.
That was Rory Ralston once again taking the football. Second down and three. They'll hand it off again, trying to come right up the middle. And we're going to get near that first down marker. In fact, we'll get beyond it. With a great second efforts right now.
It's one of those things where who wants it more? And right now it seems like the Hartley running backs and O-line wanted a little bit more than the Big Walnut defense. A little bit getting caught on their heels, not getting the push they need off the snap in the trenches. And with that, another first down, another chance for Hartley to wind down this clock all the way to halftime. You know, if you're up 12, I think you're happy if you're Hartley. But obviously, the closer this gets to about a minute or so, you can kind of rev up this offense and see if you can punch in more points.
That last run, Jay Zhang, he's a sophomore, coming in here late in the first half to get some touches.
A lot of young players we've noticed so far getting touches for the Hawks. A lot of different players, too.
Hand it off again. Zhang trying to bounce to the outside, and he still gets positive yardage. You know, funny thing is there, it was almost as though he was drug forward Big Walnut.
Yeah, it looked like he was going to have to be stopped at the line of scrimmage. Finds a way to push himself forward, and you notice in this time, Aaron Shoemade was the decoy. He was the wide receiver coming back toward the quarterback. I think a couple of Big Walnut Eagle defenders weren't sure what to do, and that allowed Zhang to pick up 3 or 4 yards there.
Now the Hawks, they just will take their time. 2:26 on the game clock and still 24 seconds right now on the play clock. So they'll milk it out here.
Yeah. I don't think there's any time to rush until about a minute left is when you really need to kind of step on the gas. Clock's going to stop after every first down regardless, and you have a timeout to work with.
Going to hand it off. The man coming around, that's Winbush. And Winbush avoids the first man, not the second man, as this time getting in there to make the tackle for Big Walnut is Eli Helton. He has been around the ball tonight. Yep. That's the first time he's been able to complete the play.
Yeah, I've noticed on a lot of those jet sweep, he's the guy who has, it seems like, the same amount of speed as those Hartley players to come out and make that tackle that needs to be made so they don't get around the corner.
And with Winbush going out of bounds as he was tackled, the clock is stopped with 2:04 left.
Man, it looks like Hartley called for some penalty here.
There were two fouls on the play. We had holding on the offense. That penalty is declined. We had a personal foul, line side block on the offense. 15 yards to the previous spot.
Well, that one's going to hurt, the personal foul, 15-yard penalty.
Yeah, because now you're looking at second and
second down.
You're going to get about second and 22 or so, or maybe just 20 yards. And, that hurts you right there as you had some positive momentum. And you want to just run this ball and run the clock, and that's a lot of yards to pick up.
And they will hand it off, the double handoff again. They try it for a second time. Winbush still on his feet, and he's got it back to the line of scrimmage, the original line. And it'll bring up a third down and 10.
Yeah, and like I said, that's a lot of yards to pick up. Instead, he just goes up and picks out about half of it, which is really impressive. That's the second time they've done that double handoff, and it's gone to pretty good success. Not sure what the officials are talking about now, though. Don't see a flag on the field, but assuming there's no flag there, and that was just an accidental stoppage.
Well, sideline warning against Big Walnut.
If I had a dime for every time I heard sideline warning, I'd be a rich man, Bob.
Well, you'd have two dimes in this game.
That's true.
But your overall point is well taken.
Yes, it's a high school staple. That is for sure.
Third down and 10. So the Hawks are waiting for the play clock hasn't started. Now it has. See if they can get something going here, third and 10.
Yeah, and
the answer is no, because there's a timeout.
Yeah, and
they're trying to change the time of the clock, and the referee microphone cut out.
Yeah.
So he can't tell the press box how much time should be on the clock.
Well, as we set up this third and 10.
There should be a minute and 50 seconds on the clock.
Okay. Yeah, as we set up this play, third and 10 here, you got to think Hartley would love to run the ball here, obviously, and get the first down. You know, you don't get it. You force Big Walnut to use that final timeout to stop the clock and possibly get their offense back on the field with some time to do something. Or do you trust your sophomore quarterback to make a play? You know,
I might trust my sophomore quarterback to throw one of those 5 yarders and let my receiver run.
I agree. Yeah, they've been able to block fairly well downfield after that first drive. You know, and then you got a guy who can burn down there. And Ryan Perry, who knows? Let's see what happens here. But I'm with you. I might trust my quarterback to do a short pass, see what happens.
Well, and he's rolling, and he's looking to throw. And he lets it go, and that's incomplete indeed. Ryan Perry was the intended target. There is a flag in the middle of the field.
Well, let's see what this is on.
Ineligible man downfield for Hartley. That one, it took a long time to develop because they were stringing him out.
And like you said, and Perry was double too, as he should have been. I mean, that's your big threat on the outside, and Big Walnut smart to have someone on top of him in the safety, and the cornerback was right on him as well. So very, very tight window to throw that ball. He had a laser of a throw. So kudos to him there. It's going to be a tough interception to have, even if he does get both hands on it.
Well, as you can figure, we're okay with the play call because that was our guess.
Correct, exactly. Ultimately, what do we care about being right?
Right. Hey, we can only call it. We can't make sure it's complete.
Yeah.
It's just the way it is.
I think overall, though, if you're Hartley there, you had 4 minutes and 20 seconds when you got the ball. Yeah, you didn't even go very far, but you still cut off more than 2 minutes there. I think you're pretty happy with that.
Bjornson bobbles the snap of the punt, but now he gets it away, and he'll get it down to the 31-yard line.
I'll tell you what, if I'm Big Walnut, that's the second time I've seen a bad snap or at least bad handle of the snap. I'm pressuring the punter each and every time because if they did that time, they might have been able to snap the ball up right there. Instead, they kind of played more of a return game and gave him plenty of time to pick it up and still get a pretty good punt off.
Is he a soccer player?
Yes, he is. Yeah.
Well, again.
Yeah.
The feet work good.
They do.
Because when you get the hands involved, that's where the problem. No, I'm just kidding. Look, he's got it. And again, you know, as kickers go, you're playing soccer
100%.
All week. You come in for a practice here and there. You're looking to get in sync with your teammates, too.
It's so tough. Yeah. I mean, they literally had a game yesterday versus Worthington Kilborn. Right. I think he's thinking, oh, man, I just got to kick the ball. Oh, I have to catch it, too, right now.
That's right.
It's tough. I get it.
So, Big Walnut, minute 38 seconds left, and their chance to try to make something happen. They're down 14-2, and they pass to the outside, and that is ended immediately. What a job right there. Carter Dancer makes the catch and is dropped immediately, a gain of 3.
Yeah, Fidelis Ajoma just jumped that route immediately and almost came away with an interception. That's how quickly he jumped in, but nice job getting the tackle. And again, clock's going to roll, and they got very short yardage.
Now they want to get downfield, it looks like, trying to roll away from pressure. And it run the football. Opportunity here for Big Walnut, shrugging off would-be tacklers, but finally getting caught and getting brought down is Jake Neer.
I tell you what, he did a great job to even get that much yardage. I mean, right from the jump, he was under pressure. He knew it. Watch how he might have run about 50 yards here to gain about 6, but there's just nowhere to go with this ball downfield. The pressure is there. He finds enough yardage to then scoot by a few of the Hawks, but really nice job here by the Hawks defense. They're really grabbing hold of them, even more so, making sure he doesn't get that first down yardage, forcing them to either use their last time out here, or I don't know why the clock stopped there, because that clock should have been rolling. He was short.
Xavier Martin Fuller was the first guy that got to him. They give it to Severs. Severs finding a hole for the first time in this game, and up the far sideline he goes, trying to cut back to the middle, and the Hawks will bring him down at the 32-yard line.
Oh, and there's a late flag here, too, and I think that's going to be on the Hawks for a little bit extra at the end, and that's unfortunate because after giving up such a big run, Seaver's first big run of the game, you then add on another 15, and that Big Walnut, who really had nothing on offense, you're going to give them some real hope to score here. Really nice job by Seaver's again. You can tell he's a senior the way he finds those open seams, and that's... It's a close call on the late hit. He had just fallen down. You can understand why, you know, you're going for that tackle, but it's a little bit late. And like I said, now here you are, Big Walnut inside the red zone, and it's the most offensive momentum they've had.
One timeout for Big Walnut, incidentally, is what they have left in this half.
Let's see if Hartley can get that pressure on him. They're committed to throwing the ball here, it looks like.
Jake Neer. He will throw it out to the right side. Ball is caught. Carter Dancer wrapped up and brought down.
Well, the clock should have stopped. And with that, that gets Big Walnut in first and goal range. And again, they have been throwing the ball pretty much exclusively besides that Seaver's run on this drive. And they're getting rid of the ball quickly. I think that's the key, is that they know they're not going to have enough time for him to step back and really drop back and throw one deep. Now they don't have to worry about that. But now let's see if the Hawks kind of switch up their defense a little bit here. Obviously getting some pressure, but with not as much room to cover behind them, they can play up a little bit close to these wide receivers and really challenge them and Neer to make a good throw.
Official timeout on the field.
Yeah, I think that clock ran off about 3-4
seconds. 8 seconds on the clock. It'll start on the ready for play.
So, yeah, it had gotten down to 34.4, so they'll put 4 seconds back on there.
Tell you what, though, if you're the Hartley Hawks, this is the last thing you wanted to do is give them any reason going to the locker room with any kind of momentum. Big Walnut gets the ball first after halftime, too, so here's the chance to double up with the last drive in the first drive.
Seavers, he's got some room up the middle, and he's into the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, and that's a great play call. You've been throwing the ball so well. Hartley has to commit resources to make sure they slow that down, and then Seavers had no problem finding the gaps in what was a pretty paltry defensive line there, because they only have about 3 or 4 on the line and really blocked well up front. Nicely done by both Matthew Van Allman and Alexander Harpster on the O-line for Big Walnut, leading the way for Seavers to score that touchdown. And so if you're Big Walnut, now you have a reason to believe here. Your offense had done absolutely nothing, and then in a span of about 1:10, you've gone down the field and made this a one-score game.
Ryan Elliott ready to attempt the extra point. And that is good. And Big Walnut makes it a 5-point game as they trail 14-9 with 33.2 seconds left here in the first half.
And that's going to be one of those lessons for Hartley, how to finish a half, right? How to close out a half. Big Walnut did it the right way. Hartley did it the wrong way, which is those big chunk plays, the unnecessary penalties, all of it came to a head in the last minute or so there. And it cost them 7 points right before halftime. Something to talk about in the halftime locker room. Your defense had been playing great. Just got to get back to that when you come back out of the half. Because before that, the defense had completely stymied this Big Walnut offense.
Yeah, no question about that. They had been on a roll. And again, I think, you know, the penalty, not only the 15 yards, but I think a psychological kind of hit as well right there.
Yeah, 100%. I mean, that's one that now Big Walnut thinks like, well, we got them frustrated. And now you have all the confidence in the world. To think that you have, you know, enough time to punch it in. They still had a timeout to use, too. So, absolutely. But listen, this is the kind of game we thought we'd have. It's going to be tough. You knew it was going to be close. Two really good teams. A lot of good senior leadership. And even the young guys have all had a lot of playing time. So, a good game that just had a lot of penalties, as you might expect for a first game of the season for both.
High kick, and the Hawks are going to let it bounce through the end zone. So, they'll take it at the 20-yard line. And again, doesn't mean the half's over with 33 seconds left in it. You got some shifty running backs. They've been finding some holes here. You never know what can happen.
I always say you got to make the defense finish out the half as well, you know. If you got a play that you really like, just hold on to the ball. Don't make a mistake here. But, you know, no need to take a knee. I mean, you can see if you can pop one real quick. And I've never really known the Mr. Hartley offense to take a knee at the end of a half. They're They're one to see if they can possibly hit something.
Got Lathan lined up in the backfield. And he will take the ball, and he's got a little bit of room. Takes a hit, gets to about the 30-yard line. Well, again, well, they, it looked like the official on the far sideline was going to stop the clock, and then he didn't.
Yeah, the official on the far side had him at the 30. The one of the nearest had him at the 29, and that obviously means it's going to be second and short.
Latham will take it again. This time they've got the first down with only about 3 seconds left.
And I think that'll probably take us to the half there.
If it's the NFL, you just air it out.
Yeah, exactly. don't think with a sophomore quarterback can get it 69 yards down the field.
Yeah, but indeed, that is going to be the final play of the half. So Bishop Hartley started the first half by mishandling a punt. It turned into a safety for Big Walnut. Then it was all Bishop Hartley, who scored two touchdowns, one via the offense, the other with the defense. And then Big Walnut got an opportunity right near the end of the half and was able to punch in a late touchdown. And that's how we've gotten to where we are right now. 14-9 is the score here. But for the Hawks, a lot of positives that they're taking into that locker room here for the half. And for Big Walnut, a lot of discussion about things that they can certainly do better in the second half.
Absolutely. Their defense really needs to tighten up against that Hartley offense. Yeah, they got to stop on that last drive, but Hartley really wasn't on the gas too much. Their offense, though, did finally see some positive momentum. So if they can keep that up as they get the ball first out of the second half, there's a chance for you to take the lead and really put the pressure back on Hartley.
Yes, indeed. So 14-9, that's what we're looking at here at Bishop Hartley High School, the opening weekend of high school football here in Ohio. And we've got a good one going between these two teams here tonight. So you're watching Bishop Hartley football here on Yamo Media.
Today's broadcast is presented by Columbus Painting Company. Call us for a free estimate at 614-818-8028 or visit cbuspaintingcompany.com. By the Mortgage Captain. Need guidance on your home buying journey? Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331. By Yamo Media. Be on the lookout for the new Yamo Media app, soon to be available on the Android and Apple Store, as well as yamomedia.com. By Training ABC. Employee training courses that are simply better. Visit trainingabc.com for more information. And by PageTech. Take your event to the next level with PageTech Limited. Visit us at PageTechLTD.com for more information.
They told me, I didn't worry about it. We put a pattern in the car and have the best for you.
Thank you.
Today's broadcast is presented by Columbus Painting Company. Call us for a free estimate at 614-818-8028 or visit cbuspaintingcompany.com. By the Mortgage Captain. Need guidance on your home buying journey? Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331. By Yamo Media. Be on the lookout for the new Yamo Media app, soon to be available on the Android and Apple Store, as well as yamomedia.com. By Training ABC, employee training courses that are simply better. Visit trainingabc.com for more information. And by PageTech. Take your event to the next level with PageTech Limited. Visit us at PageTechLTD.com for more information. Is presented by Columbus Painting Company. Call us for a free estimate at 614-818-8028 or visit cbuspaintingcompany.com. By the Mortgage Captain. Need guidance on your home buying journey? Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331. By Yamo Media. Be on the lookout for the new Yamo Media app, soon to be available on the Android and Apple Store, as well as yamomedia.com. By Training ABC, employee training courses that are simply better. Visit trainingabc.com for more information. And by PageTech. Take your event to the next level with PageTech Limited. Visit us at PageTechLTD.com for more information.
So when you use the word transforms, it's a really powerful word, but I think it's appropriate and necessary what we do at Bishop Hartley. Being around this school for most of my life, I've seen the power of our community, and it's really in the people and our communal faith, our communal excellence, what we do together. I've been so blessed to be a part and then come back here to see what this school has given me, but what we give other people.
Bishop Hartley has a uniquely holistic approach to education. We have 100% college acceptance rate, a ton of great AP courses and dual enrollment courses, so the academics are on point. But the fact that we care about students as a whole child and we help them grow spiritually, socially, emotionally, that really sets kids apart to help them be the best version of themselves.
I think Hartley is transformative down to the core of who these students are. Speaking from experience as a 2007 grad, I remember myself walking in as a 14-year-old in 2003 and just being so unsure of myself and, you know, unsure of who I was and my place and my confidence. And then when I was in, you know, a senior about to graduate, I felt like I could take on whatever life threw at me.
Hartley helped me recognize that I have an interest in business through taking classes such as personal finance and marketing. I really enjoyed those, and it's something that I probably wouldn't have learned in just my typical core classes. Additionally, in my government class, I've got to learn about a lot of law cases and Supreme Court decisions, and that has kind of fueled my interest in law.
Bishop Hartley prepared me for the future in many ways. One of the big decisions when choosing Hartley was because of the faith-based education and then the very diverse environment it has.
My Engineering Your World 1 class for sure cemented my idea of being an engineer. I really love the class. We solve a lot of problems and we learn how to do a lot of things in the engineering field.
After Hartley, I'm going to major in musical theater. I don't know where I'm going yet, but I have a lot of good schools. I actually got accepted into my dream school for musical theater. I mean, it would be cool to end up on Broadway.
Bishop Hartley really helps transform our students as a community to prepare them for, you know, being productive citizens in society. It's not just academics or athletics or faith, it's all three. I'm preparing students for what lies ahead.
When I think of how Hartley has transformed people over the years, what comes to mind most is students who come in as 13-year-old kids, and over the 4 years, they become Hawks. They become a family, and they leave as graduates and will always be a family of Hawks together.
One thing that Hartley transforms is student prospects. So if you take a good student, you give them state-winning sports, you give them AP courses, and then you allow them to have that Catholic education, you take a good student and you transform into a Hartley Hawk.
The first transformation I saw from Bishop Hartley was none other than my own many years ago. So as a teacher, I wanted to share that transformation with my students. Along the way, I also shared it with my own two children who came to Bishop Hartley. So I know the effects it can have. We have an expression, always a hawk, and that's very true. Once you enter this building as a hawk, we kind of hold on to you forever. And it's nice to know that you have that faith community, that family community behind you wherever you go and whatever you do.
My favorite aspect at Hartley, I would probably have to say, is the house system. Being able to like see the different like people in your house and getting to see different grade levels, it just brings a really good like aspect of community.
Having all like the staff members and like people here, like my peers and stuff, definitely has like helped me get through stuff, especially when I have like big projects or like a deadline that's really close coming up.
The Evening of Excellence is such an amazing evening when we get all these people together to celebrate and really push the mission of Bishop Hartley, which is transforming lives through the teachings of Jesus Christ within the Catholic tradition. And having you all together coming to this evening to support what our future is, but also honor our past, is a powerful experience. And I've seen it grow to do such amazing things from the packages we offer, but the generosity of this community really sets it apart.
I've had the pleasure of working with thousands of nervous eighth graders and watching them transform through their Hartley experience into Joyce Scholars, QuestBridge recipients, lawyers, priests, teachers. And now you have the opportunity to transform kids' lives and help Bishop Hartley grow our legacy.
Thank you from us at Bishop Hartley for your support, for your continued guidance, and your continued prayers. Go Hawks.
Welcome to the 32nd Evening of Excellence. Give a round of applause. Thank you.
thank you up front at $2,500. Round of applause. Thank you for your donation, sir.
All the students and staff and administration of Hartley and alums, thank you so much for being here for the Evening of Excellence. Have a good night. We'll see you next year.
Back here at Bishop Hartley, opening weekend. The Hartley Hawks and Bishop Walnut. Tonight's broadcast presented by Columbus Painting Company. Locally owned small business, Columbus Painting Company is your choice for high-quality interior and exterior painting. CPC also provides power washing, fence and deck scanning and staining, gutter clean out, plus drywall and trim repair. Let them help you get your home looking fresh and ready for football watch parties this fall. Call them at 614-818-8028 for a free estimate today, or visit ColumbusPaintingCompany.com to learn more about their services. 14-9, the Bishop Hartley Hawks have the lead over Big Walnut. It was a trying first half for the Eagles of Big Walnut, but they actually got the first points, and it came on this mishandled punt and a safety.
Yeah, absolutely. Good job by Joe Wooten of the Hawks for recovering that for the safety, but Big Walnut, I'm sure they wish they could make that a touchdown instead if they could have fallen on that football first after the botched punt.
They really do wish they could have made it a touchdown, because as it would go on, Hartley would start to get in sync offensively and find a way to get things going. A little double handoff action right here. We've seen that play a couple times.
We haven't. Both times it's gone for big yardage. Bryson Winbush, one of the stars of the first half, the way he's been able to elude tackles and get positive yardage.
Well, the Hawks defensively getting the job done too. And we're talking about pressure. Near, the quarterback for Big Walnut, he has been chased all night long.
Poor Jake Near sees Denham cooking his nightmares already. It's only been the first half. He has been in the backfield numerous times, really making it tough for the offense to get moving.
Here's where Hartley was able to get on the board with their offense, just powering the football. Lathan with the pitch. He'll get help in front and behind.
And with that, it was when Hartley scoring the first touchdown of this game, and a game that had been tightly contested so far in the trenches. Hartley at that time really starting to take it over.
And then the Hartley defense, they showed that they came to play as well. And it was a throw that was picked off. Brandon Lorette into the end zone.
Yeah, and once again, it was Cook with the presser, Lorette with the pick. The defense getting a touchdown, the offense with a touchdown. Hartley seemed to be flying high right then.
But then Big Walnut, right near the end of the first half, they get an opportunity and they cash in on it.
Yeah, this is where Nate Sievers, that senior leadership, really comes to play. They did a really nice job composing themselves in the final minute, finding a way to get into the end zone, making this a one-score game. And just like that, the game that we thought it would be nice and close throughout the way is after one half.
And the Hartley Hawks took the opening kickoff in the first half. That means that Big Walnut will get the ball to start the second half here tonight. And they just want to simply get it and do what they did on that last offensive drive, get some points on the board.
Exactly. And it seemed, you know, Hartley's defense might have changed a little bit in that last little drive there, trying to maybe milk the clock a little bit, and Big Walnut took advantage. But I will say kudos to Big Walnut, finding a way to get some positive momentum here. But now it's a matter of, can it carry over out of the locker room? And as you think about Hartley with their defense, boy, you know they are looking to lick their chops and really find a way to get back to that aggressive defense they were in, back in the backfield, not allowing those big long runs from Nate Sievers. They really played a good first half besides that last minute. So here's a chance to impose your will once again, find a way to get that offense back on the field, which had been playing really well in the second quarter.
So the waiting is the hardest part. That's how the song goes. And we're down to about 22 seconds before they will tee that ball up at the 40-yard line and kick it away to get this second half underway. It will be interesting to see, as you talked about changes, what changes did these coaches make during the halftime. Big Walnut, not happy whatsoever. And that message was, I walked by there, it was conveyed pretty clearly.
Was it? I can imagine it, especially considering they really got the ball moving by throwing the ball in that last drive. Maybe they go back to that short pass game, see if they can get that moving. Because running the ball, they were really having trouble. Besides a couple Sievers runs in that last drive, they were really getting bottled up by that Hartley defensive line. So we shall see. Maybe they decide to go through the air a little bit more to move that football.
Now the Hawks, they are set, and they are ready to go. And you can see that Bjornson is now finally given the go-ahead to kick it off and get the second half underway. Two men deep for Big Walnut. Previous two kickoffs have been short ones, and this one is as well. Little chip shot, checks up at the 18-yard line, picked up at the 20, And Big Walnut's going to get out to about the 25-yard line. You know, you talked about Bjornsson being a new kicker and looking to find that, you know, that soft spot where you can put the ball. Yep. That was it.
That was perfect. I think if you start the ball at the 25 every time, especially if you know you don't have the leg to get it all the way to the touchback and start them at the 20, that's exactly where you want to put them, a spot where they have to pick up the ball. It's already dead or, you know, stopped, and then you have no momentum to really move forward. So really nice job by Bob Bjornsson there.
So let's see what Jake Neer does. As you mentioned, they threw the ball more quickly on the last drive of the first half. That was key because Hartley had great penetration and pressure throughout the first half. Here it's going to be a quick handoff to Severs. He breaks two tackles. He's to the outside, and he's got about eight.
Yeah, that was good blocking by the offensive line there. He had a gap between the tackle and the guard and found a way to get the yardage there. That's what Hartley was not allowing much of in the first half. Let's see if, again, Big Walnut maybe figured something out, maybe challenged their offensive line to really push that pile to give Severs a little bit more room. And he doesn't need much. He's a good running back.
They mark him down at 7, second down and 3. Neer mishandles the snap a bit, hands it off, and they're not going to get much on this. Looks like they're right back to around the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, that was a nice blitz there, but it looked like Rory Ralston got through the offensive line, kind of threw off the timing of this whole play. Yeah, he had to cut back in, and nice job by, it looks like, Donovan Davis there, making the final tackle on the play to leave him no gain. But a nice job by the Hawks after giving up a long gain on the first down, finding a way to get him to no gain, force his third down.
Saw Garrett Stover with a big play early in the game. Hadn't seen him touch the ball since. They fake it to him here. Neers wants to throw, and he does. He's got Severs, and now it's a foot race down the far sideline, and Severs gets knocked out of bounds. Looks like he's inside the 45 down to about the 42-yard line.
And that's the first time we've seen that, the fake handoff and the rollout. And Severs, boy, when he gets the ball, he's got some speed. You see him running away from Joey Wooten there along the sideline there. It seemed like Hartley had this one figured out pretty well, but then Severs with just enough distance from Wooten to catch the ball and keep going on the run.
Severs again puts his head down, but not going to get much this time.
And you see Big Walnut going a little faster now, too. Think they can feel that Hartley a little bit on their toes on defense, so now they can maybe ramp up this pace a little bit and maybe catch them a little bit off guard and get some quick yardage.
Well, another key to this is, and you talked about this before the game started, you've got a Hartley team where a lot of the players play both offense and defense. So you get into the second half, you turn up the intensity a little bit, you turn up the speed, you try to wear on these guys.
Absolutely. Why wouldn't you? If you got, you know, you just came out of halftime, you've got fresh legs right now. Here's your chance to really get them going, and then maybe that'll slow them down on offense too.
Neer, the handoff. Stover looking for room. Oh, and he is pushed backwards. Great job by the defense of the Hawks that time.
Yeah, that's Jay Zhang right there. You know what they say, when you're going up with a big player, don't go for the top half, go for the bottom half. Watch him just drive it over his knees and thighs, not allowing him to get going. Look at that. He's going backward because he's going low. I just want to give a shout out because Mr. Zhang's a wrestler. I think he understands that's where all the momentum is, all right? That Zhang family has all been wrestlers, and that showed right there.
Third down at about 5. First drive of the second half. Big Walnut down by 5 points. Take the snap. Neer with time. Now he's running out of that time. But he throws toward the middle, and that is going to be caught for a first down. And down to the 25-yard line. Go the Eagles.
Yeah, that was a nice throw there by Neer. A really nice pass, and he had to throw across his body there. But here's the pressure. Watch this, and it looks like there might have been a hold there by the center. That's Alexander Harpster. It looked like he might have gotten a hold, but instead, don't call that. And again, nice pass and catch there.
Pollock with the catch. Neer, he's got pressure. He is trying to roll away, and he cannot do it.
I tell you what, Zhang again in the backfield. How about that? And listen, he left his feet, jumped in the air. You thought that would be the chance for Neer to get outside the pocket and get away. Watch him just jump up and kind of stay right there. No, you're not going anywhere. I got you. Grabbed the jersey, brought him down, getting a little help from his friends, Brendan Lorette. Nice play on first down for that Hartley defense.
Huge play on that first down. 7-yard loss on the play, second down 17.
And that'll force Big Walnut to slow down just a little bit there.
Neer fakes a handoff, and he is caught, loses his helmet, and that play's got to be dead immediately.
It does. But here's the, I know they threw a flag here, but I'm...
You can't... Well, I'm going to wait and see what they decide here, what they talk about. You can't assume they're going to blow the whistle. You got to be kidding me. a face mask penalty.
So they do call a face mask, and I don't. My question is, did he actually grab that face mask? I mean, I guess because the helmet came off, they have to do it. I know when the helmet comes off, the play is dead. I do know that.
Yeah.
But I do want to get a replay of this, and or did this helmet just fall off? It looks like his left hand may have grabbed it. Yeah. And that's unfortunate because that was a clean look for an easy sack. And just when he ducked his head, his hand just in the wrong spot. Yeah, that's Xavier Martin Fuller. That's just unfortunate because, boy, he had a sack ready made for him.
Severs trying to go through the right side. And he's going to be close to that first down. It's right at about the 15-yard line.
Yeah, it looks like the official's going to give that to him. So, boy, you had it at second and very long. That penalty and then that short run gives him a first down just like that. But you're already seeing, though, that Hartley defense is still finding a way to get into the backfield. Despite this quick pace of this offense, you can see Big Walnut trying to take advantage of it with these quick runs up the middle, trying to combat those outside rushes. But if Hartley defense can kind of stick to their keys, what they need to do, they should be able to slow this down.
Hand it off again, and this time there is no room. Good job by the Hartley defense. Loretta, the first guy there to shut the door.
Yeah, exactly. That first contact really slowed all the momentum that Severs had to go forward. Really nice job by the Hartley defense there. That Big Walnut offensive line has been starting to get a push, but not enough of one here. He just had nowhere to go. They filled all those gaps, and no gain for the running back, who seems to be finding gaps left and right here in these last couple of drives.
Put Stover back there in the backfield with Severs, flanking the quarterback. Fake the handoff to Severs. They want to throw near to the end zone, and that ball is incomplete.
And that, frankly, almost should have been an interception. Fidel Sajoma was the one who broke that up. I was just going to say, this isn't a play that had been working for them, this fake handoff and then a rollout. He had had a couple open receivers. This time, he was not open at all. Hartley had this one read from night until day. Stover covered in the flat, and then down the field, Jomo jumps the route, nearly picks it off. Really nice job of the Hartley defense, making sure they force a third down there.
Third down and nine. Big play right here for the Hawks, because then it forces them to make a decision.
Yeah, and they have a kicker that clearly has a leg for this, but will they actually make that decision?
Fake the handoff again. Here comes the pressure, and the tackle is made. Another sack by the Hawks, and right there, Donovan Davis.
Donovan Davis with a little help from Xavier Martin Fuller, the cornerback on the outside. I mean, this was exactly what the Hartley defense needed right here. That fake does absolutely nothing. Look at Martin Fuller get around the edge. Davis had no one blocking him, and between the two of them, this is an easy sack, and now it forces Big Walnut into a tough decision. A long field goal. Or do you go for it? And it looks like they're going to opt for the field goal here. And this is no cupcake here.
Nope. It is not going to be easy. They're going to spot the football. It's going to be spotted at the 30-yard line. That's a 40-yard kick.
Now, judging from the extra points, we know he has plenty of leg. It's just a matter of having the leg and the accuracy to make this one.
And the kick is up. And that kick is good. Wow. 40-yard field goal for Big Walnut, and they get something out of that drive, and they cut the lead to 2 points for the Hartley Hawks. It's 14-12.
Yeah. This is kind of a win-win for both teams, you feel like. Hartley's happy to get out of that, only get up a field goal after that ball got into the red zone. Big Walnut happy to come away with points after a couple of defensive plays by the Hawks really set them back. All in all, what a drive, and then what a defensive stand, and then a heck of a field goal. That ball just kind of lingered in the air over the crossbar and crawled over.
Tell you something, that is a weapon in high school football, isn't it?
Anything, any field goal kicker that can make anything 35 and longer, huge weapon.
And Big Walnut, they took a good bit of time off the clock there, too. Only 6:06 remaining. They took about half the quarter away.
They did.
On that drive.
But with that said, they're still losing, and that's the issue with that. If Hartley comes out here and comes back and scores, you're back down 8 or 9, and that puts pressure right back on the Eagles. So this is where Hartley's got to do what they did in the second quarter of the first half, which was a nice long drive, put the points on the board, and really have the Eagles have to rush on offense once again. And Hartley's very capable of doing that with the running backs that they have, and they, to their credit, have used a plethora of the running backs. They should also have fresh legs, because only about 5 or 6 carries for each one, the way they've been spreading the ball out.
Well, the Hawks looking for a nice return here on this kickoff. They haven't been able to return one yet. All the kickoffs have gone through the end zone, And this one is not going to be any exception. That one is through as well. Bishop Hartley would like to thank Page Tech Limited and Training ABC for being presenting sponsors of tonight's broadcast. Their sponsorship of the school's Evening of Excellence helps to make broadcasts like this possible. Training ABC helps to develop training videos and courses for your organization. Visit trainingabc.com. Page Tech Limited can help you to turn your event into a dazzling affair. Visit PageTech.com today and learn more. Bishop Hartley, once a Hawk, always a Hawk. And Matt Barnes knows that more than anybody.
That is true.
No matter how many times you try to get away, they pull you back.
They pull you back.
Here's a handoff. And coming around the near side up to the 30-yard line. Boy, the Hawks are going to pick themselves up. First down. Good job there as they get... Ryan Perry involved in the offense once again.
And that's a name that we thought we'd say more and more, actually, and we actually haven't had said name too much. They've done a really nice job neutralizing him in the pass game. Here, the chance to get him involved in the run game with the jet sweep, and they did a really nice job getting around that corner. Eagles had done a nice job neutralizing those outside runs, but not that time.
Jet sweep, a play that's been a weapon for this team for a long time. Haven't seen much of it so far here tonight. There's been plenty of other plays that they've run, but good success on that one. Here's a pitch back. Robert Latham Jr. He cuts to the inside. He's got a first down. He's got more. He's in the open field. Latham angling toward the far sideline. He'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line.
Holy cutback on that one. My goodness. He had a nice block. You think it might go for 5 yards. He cuts back to the inside, turns on the jets, and away he goes. Check out this replay. Really nice blocking up front. Check out the tight end, right guard, doing a really nice job, giving him a chance to get around there. Nice shot by Ralston, too, with a kickout block. But then the rest of this is all Latham and his speed, running away from that Eagle defense for the long gain. And that's exactly what the Hawks needed to get some momentum and excitement back into this crowd and on that sideline.
They have it set up just inside the 20-yard line. First down and 10 for the Hawks.
And if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Keep on running the ball.
And they do. The quick handoff this time. And again, another play that looks like it should be one that goes for about three.
Yeah, and that's because Roy Ralston is a big dude. Again, he gets hit that first time. He takes it, but he just keeps on ticking and gets another 2 yards there. And each one of these yards, when you get inside the red zone, matter because it's going to be four down territory, frankly, for the Hawks. So a little bit closer, a little bit closer. Nice job by him not allowing himself to go down for no gain there.
Officially, they give him 2, 2nd down and 8. Two receivers to the top of the screen. One to the bottom. Golich looks like he's changing the play. Doing it with 10 seconds left on the play clock. Plenty of time to make sure everybody is all set and snap the football. Fakes a handoff. They give it to Latham. Comes around the right side. He's got a blocker. And then that Big Walnut did a good job. Even with that blocker out of there, they kind of came inside of him, and they held Latham to a short game.
Yeah, I was going to say, when he first got the ball and he went around that corner, I thought that might be a touchdown. So they did a nice job surrounding him to make sure he didn't get more than that. You see, he's trying to find a way to juke around, but really nice tackle there by Aiden West to make sure he stopped himself short of the goal of the line to gain. With that said, nice job by the sophomore quarterback. Looked like he did change the call at the line, and he saw something he didn't like on the first call, changed it to find a way to get 5 yards on a nice carry.
Well, as you said, four down territory, but right now it's 3rd down and 3. See if they can get these 3 yards in this play. They give it to Latham again. He's got blockers, and he puts the head down, and he's down to about the 5-yard line.
Yeah, that's one of those plays that as you see it run, you know it's not going to go for a touchdown. There's not enough room for him to get to the end zone, but you know he's got the first down too because he's got a cavalcade of blockers there to keep the Eagles from getting to him. By the time he gets hit, he's already got 6 yards, well past the first down line, and now you're all set up to punch it into the end zone in 4 plays here.
Great patience by him. Right pace to let those guys, Joey Wooten and his teammates, get out there and make those blocks.
I mean, make it easier for yourself and let them do the work and then just follow the big boys.
First and goal from the 7. They'll hand it off to Roy Ralston, and he finds his way to the end zone.
Yeah, this is one of those plays that no matter how you scout this, if you're Big Walnut, it's almost impossible to know who's going to get the ball. You have an up man, you have a middle guy, and you have the 3 guys behind him. Who's going to get the ball in this I formation? Well, you know one's going to block probably, but then is it going to be Ralston? Is it going to be the guy behind him? In this case, it is Ralston. The Eagles aren't prepared for it. He finds an easy gap around the left guard. In to the end zone for the touchdown. So nice job by Hartley. Their great response to the drive by Big Walnut puts them back on their heels. And their defense still trying to figure out what they can do to slow down this rush attack from the Hawks.
Malik Tufts with a great job of blocking on that touchdown for Rory Ralston. Here's the extra point attempt, which is good. And it's now 21-12.
And each one of those extra points is going to get bigger and bigger for Bjornsson there. He's got to convert each one of those to make sure it's a two-score game. He does that once again. Nice job by the kicker. And again, nice job overall with the response by the Hawks. That's what you needed to do after Big Walnut had gone back-to-back scores on you, getting 10 unanswered. Now you come back, take the momentum right back from them. And let's see if your defense has maybe recovered after that opening drive where Big Walnut, again, went right down the field on you, helped again by another penalty, which happened on the other touchdown drive. And maybe you can kind of calm down and keep them from getting into the end zone or on the scoreboard at all.
Yeah, very good point. Both touchdowns for Big Walnut. There was a personal foul. There was one near the end of the first half. There was the face mask penalty here in the second half that gave those big 15 yards. And Big Walnut, to their credit, they took advantage of both of those, used that 15 yards to find their way to the end zone. The end zone and then to the uprights on the field goal.
Yeah, I mean, that's what good teams do. They take advantage of the mistakes. And 15 yards is such a big deal in these games. But so tightly contested game. Both defenses have played fairly well. But 15 yards is such a big gain when you really haven't done anything on offense.
See if Bjornsson can find that soft spot again. He does. He bounces it at the 20, and it almost got away. Big Walnut trying to come laterally. Now the 25 up the middle of the field, cross midfield and into Hartley territory all the way to the 30-yard line as the Eagles answer with a big play. Actually, a huge play, to be quite honest with you there.
Yeah, really nice job there by the Eagles. A ball picked up around the 20. That was a Brody Hadfield. And he finds a gap. And, you know, this is one of those things where you got to stay in your lane. Stay in your lane, and this doesn't happen. But, you know, you get a little out of your lane, and all it takes is one. There's the gap, and he had some speed, and there he goes.
Handed off to Severs. Looking for running room. Stays on his feet. Powers his way for five to the 25-yard line, and one of the Hawks is down.
Oh, and that looks like a cramp, I tell you. I just feel like we see this a little often in week one. Yeah, he's already up, and yeah. And again, you're going to see this in the first week. You're learning that hydration technique that you got to have for a football game, a 48-minute game. And that one just, I'm not saying it doesn't hurt, but you know you got to do a little bit better on the day before to make sure that doesn't happen for you.
So this is a second down and five. It was Ryo Hogan that went off, by the way. And here's a handoff and Severs trying to keep leaning forward. And he does. He gets inside the 20 to the 19.
Yeah, he was dragging Denham Cook, and that's not easy to do. Denham Cook, one of the best, finest players on this field right now. And he was dragging him on those last three or four yards and dragging him past the first down line as another Hawk player now down on the field on his knee there. Can't tell who it is. Just like Donovan Davis there. And that's who it is indeed.
Yeah, it is. And again, not the guy you want to lose. You want to lose any guy for any play, but especially that guy.
Yeah, exactly. He's been such a run stuffer in the middle of that defensive line. And again, good to see him kind of hobbling off there. Again, looks like another one of those kind of cramp situations. Stretch him out, get some water in him, and maybe be good to go.
Well, in the meantime, Big Walnut, if you're looking to keep running the ball with Severs, to have the big man out of there right now, is probably something that appeals to you.
And what did we talk about earlier? Again, a lot of the Hartley guys go both ways, and this might be part of that attrition that, you know, if they can keep the pace up, it's going to make it tough for them.
Severs this time caught from behind and brought down.
Joey Wooten jumping on his back. That was fantastic play by him coming around the right side and watching go all the way across the line. And Severs has no chance. Doesn't even know he's behind him. Almost going to punch that ball out and gotten a fumble, but really nice job bringing him down for a very, very short gain, if at all.
Well, they put it right back at the original line of scrimmage. Second down and 10. Stover takes it this time and trying to stay on his feet. Good job to stand him up, and finally the whistle comes.
So, again, you're seeing Big Walter pick up that pace, but it's not necessarily adding up all the way to getting more yards sometimes. In that case, they ran up the middle. Hartley was ready to go. Short gain. looked like Denham Cook stood him up and had some help from his friends to make sure he couldn't go any further. But these are the plays that matter now, these third down plays. Again, they're back in field goal range. We know the kicker has the leg. Can they stop them from getting into fourth and short or obviously getting the first down as well?
Fake the handoff and a throw toward the end zone. And it is caught for the touchdown. A little fake handoff and rollout, which has worked well for Big Walnut in this second half.
Yeah, really nice play here. It looked like Neer had nowhere to go. I'm looking down the field. I didn't see anybody, but I guess all of a sudden Ben Ronk was going left and then cut back to the right. He's wide open. Well, I guess not wide open. Pretty good coverage, actually. It's a really nice throw on the run there by Neer. And that's a really nice response by Big Walnut. So the defense has really took the stage in the first half, second half. It's the offenses that have really been the stars so far.
Yes, indeed. So the big touchdown catch by Ben Ronk. And the extra point is good. And all of a sudden, it's right back to nip and tuck, 21-19.
Offensive explosion all of a sudden in this third quarter. Two touchdowns and a field goal. Both defenses playing at a pretty quick pace here. That's going to be wearing them down, and maybe that's allowing the offense to spread their legs a little. So it's funny because, again, the first quarter we saw these defenses really taking charge. Offenses were really nervous, not in sync. Now it's the other way around as these offenses are really doing well.
Revolution Mortgage. Need guidance on your home buying journey? You can contact Todd Ultrup at Revolution Mortgage. Todd also is known as the mortgage captain. He's a trusted advisor that will help you navigate the process and help you land your dream home. Call Todd at 614-618-3331. Revolution Mortgage is an equal housing opportunity lender. Well, what the Hawks could use right now is one of those good old patented nine-minute drives.
Absolutely, yeah.
With a touchdown.
With a touchdown. Got to cap it off, exactly, because it's a two-point game. You know they got a field goal kicker that is dangerous. Don't want this to come down to a field goal kick at all. That could give Big Walnut the lead.
Another touchback on the kick. And once again, the Hawks will come out to the 20-yard line to get things started here. As we've got under a minute to play in the third quarter of this game.
Fun game, that's for sure. For the week one, what a matchup. What a contest. Great weather for this. Great crowd. Can't ask for much more in a week one matchup. You know, sometimes you get those lopsided ones. You're thinking, what did either team get out of this? I think both teams are going to get a lot out of this matchup.
I think you're right. I think they are. They're going to get a lot of film to study this week, and one of them is going to be real happy about it. The other one's going to be pretty disappointed. Here's a fake of a handoff. No, they did hand it off. And there is a flag that was thrown there. That's not a flag.
No, that was the beanbag, yeah. Which, by the way, I hate the fact they changed the beanbag color to a color closer to yellow instead of it being white like it used to be. But that's rather near here nor there. I could argue that for days. But, yeah, I got to be honest. I didn't know who really had this ball. Maybe it was a fumble, actually. Yeah, it was. That ball was on the ground. And nice job by Bryson Wimbush picking it up and finding a way to grab some positive yardage.
Now we have a Big Walnut player that's got looks like cramping over on the far side of the field.
Yep. That.
Well, it's funny. We talked about this before the game, you and I, before we went on the air. You said maybe because it's a little bit cooler tonight, we won't have all that cramping that you get in week one and week two. And we were great for the first half.
Yeah.
But here in the second half, after all of the physical exertion, you're seeing some guys having to deal with it.
And I think it's no surprise either. We've seen the pace of this game pick up, too. A lot more running, a lot of longer plays. The offenses are deciding to snap the ball a little faster. Less time for rest. Yeah, we're seeing those typical week one cramps. And, again, it happens in almost every high school football game in the state. You were hoping the weather was going to maybe minimize it a little bit. But these guys will learn again. It's that first week of preparation for a game on Friday night. What you need to do to get your body right so that doesn't happen.
All right. So now we're ready to get back and get going here with 38.2 seconds left in the third quarter of a two-point game, 21-19. The two-point difference. The reason it's 2 points, there was a safety that was put up by Big Walnut back in the first quarter. So Hartley ready to run a second down and 8 play.
And look at the formation here. 3 wide to the right. Does that mean pass, or are we just going to run the ball again?
Tell you in a second. As soon as it gets snapped, and there's a long snap count.
They don't have to snap it either.
No. Nope.
Looking at the play clock,
and that might be what we're doing. Only 12 seconds on the play clock, 9 seconds on the game clock. As long as everybody can hold their position and not rock back there from that offensive line, and they don't. They hold their position, and the third quarter ends. It's 21-19. Bishop Hartley with the lead over Big Walnut.
Today's broadcast is presented by Columbus Painting Company. Call us for a free estimate at 614-818-8028 or visit cbuspaintingcompany.com. By the Mortgage Captain. Need guidance on your home buying journey? Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331. By Yamo Media. Be on the lookout for the new Yamo Media app, soon to be available on the Android and Apple Store, as well as yamomedia.com. By Training ABC, employee training courses that are simply better. Visit trainingabc.com for more information. And by PageTech. Take your event to the next level with PageTech Limited. Visit us at PageTechLTD.com for more information.
Bob McElligott, Matt Barnes with you here at Bishop Hartley High School. The Hawks with a 2-point lead over Big Walnut as we are set to start the fourth quarter. Second down and 8 for the Hartley Hawks. And they will pitch the ball to the near sideline. Much room there? No, is the answer to that. And they run out of bounds just across the 25. But that's going to leave a third down and 5.
Yeah, haven't called Aaron Shoemate's name very much since that first quarter, but gets the carry there. But again, short side, they do a nice job stringing that out. Again, the sidelines are 12th defender there for Big Walnut. They do a nice job utilizing that. So critical third down here for the Hawks. You want to get this first down and keep this drive alive, keep that clock moving. Big Walnut obviously wants to get the third down stop, get their offense back on the field where they have gotten some positive momentum in this second half.
Single setback. Now they start to pinch everybody in. Maybe a man in motion. There it goes. It's Winthrop. And here's a pass, and it is caught, and it's going to be short of the first down.
Yeah, that's one where Gallick would love to have that pass back. Lead him a little bit more so he doesn't have to go to the ground. And, of course, in high school, you hit the ground, you are down. In the NFL, he would have gotten up, maybe rolled to that first down. But, yeah, nothing really Larek could do there once he catches that ball. He's got to catch it, and he's down right there. So the play was there, right play call. Just execution a little off there. Sophomore quarterback, he'll learn. Got to put that ball in a better spot to allow the receiver to catch and run and get the first down. Or if he is going to do that, make sure that pass is past the sticks.
Huge play coming up here with Bjornson punting. He has had trouble handling the football. He handles this one, and he gets it away. And a fair catch called for at the 45-yard line. So not looking to be a hero right there on that play was Brady Hatfield. And why not? You're set up at the 45-yard line. Big defensive stand for Big Walnut that time.
100%. They had been getting gashed on the offense, or on the defense, I should say, by the Hartley offense, especially on that the previous drive before this one where the long run by Lathan. So really nice job by them getting the stop. Now can their offense keep the momentum they've been having? They've been doing a really nice job with the run game. It was the passing game at the end of the second quarter. The run game has really gotten them going now here.
So they're ready to go to work. Jake Neer, senior quarterback, hands it off quickly and up to the 50-yard line. Another gain of 5 for Nate Severs.
That is Nate Severs indeed. Yeah, again, they had his ankle. That was Lorette grabbing his ankle, but he finds a way to drag him for another couple yards, picks up half the distance of those 10 yards he needed. So, again, getting up to the line here. Neer's got him up there, and they're trying to go fast again.
Near rolling, keeps it himself, takes a hit, he's got the first down. Just gets across the 45-yard line. And don't forget, you're down by 2. They've shown they can get to the 30-yard line and maybe get the lead back. There's a 40-yard field goal that was kicked earlier. Here's something Neer hasn't done a lot today, keep it himself.
I was going to say the same thing. Yeah, he's a man that can definitely run the ball. He showed he can do that last year. He had 36 rush yards in their game last year, but that's the first time he's done the QB keeper. Oh, boy.
Oh, great job by the defense coming up with a huge play and a loss of 5. Denham Cook right there. What a job.
There goes that man once again, right? Denham Cook the junior three-star who is just wreaking havoc. Really nice job first. Let's give some credit to the defensive tackle who got in there first for the Hawks. I mean, well done. Denham Cook is kind of cleaning that play up, but five-yard loss, huge.
Second down and 15. Near will slow it down now. Look to the sidelines. See those two receivers at the bottom of your screen. And he's looking that way, and he's got some time. Now he rolls. That time running out. Near trying to get whatever he can, and Roy Ralston brings him down at the 48.
Well, first off, the first bit of credit goes to that offensive line. They are protecting him in the pocket. He had all day to throw that ball. But then more credit goes to the defensive backs of Hartley. They did a great job keeping him from having anyone to throw to. And then by that time, he just had to tuck it and run. And nice job by Jay Zhang making sure he couldn't go anywhere too far, only getting 2 yards on that scramble. So nice job of the Hawks standing tall in the backfield as well as making sure Neer couldn't get any big yardage.
Yeah, that was Zhang, 45. And that's the second time he's kind of isolated somebody and frozen them in the middle of the field.
Not easy to do with Neer either. He's quick.
Third down and long. Big defensive play right here for the Hartley Hawks, and we're going to get a whistle and a timeout called by Big Walnut with 8:44 left.
Yeah, I think they thought the same thing. Big defensive play for Hartley, big offensive play for Big Walnut. They want to keep this ball, 8:44 to go in the game. If you can find a way to pick up half this yardage, give yourself a fourth down chance, but, boy, a sack really would hurt here, so get the right play call in.
And a sack not out of the question. We've seen that a couple of times already by the Hartley defense on these big plays, getting through when they need to get through. So everybody wants to talk it out and make sure that they're on the right page.
Absolutely. I think if you're Big Wano, you're thinking, man, is there a way we get near outside the pocket where you can maybe roll out, find a wide receiver, get 5-6 yards, and let them do the work? If you're Hartley, if there's any way you can kind of contain him in the pocket and then let your D lineman or linebackers find a way to get him in there and sack him down there. So a lot of things, I'm sure, being talked about in these huddles, but what a huge play here when you're so late in the game in a two-point game right around the midfield. This is a massive call here.
But again, what has been working for Big Walnut, that fake handoff, a little rollout, the pass. Do they go with that?
It's just a matter of will they have time to do the rollout, because if he doesn't have time, he is going to be on the ground in seconds.
Near sets up in the pocket. He throws downfield. This ball is picked off at the 20-yard line. And the Hawks will cut it across the field to the 30 and down at the 31-yard line.
Donovan Tucker, what a play. It was like a free safety back there. Center fielder just waiting for that ball to come down, grabs it and heads the other way. Credit to the D-line, the linebackers keeping Near in the pocket. That was good. He still had time to throw this ball. It just wasn't an accurate throw. This was definitely overthrown. Great coverage down the field. Three guys in blue, only one guy in white. And Tucker, again, doing what he has to do. Getting that ball back to the Hartley defense. And now, once again, we talked about this. Hartley can do those long 6-7-8 minute drives. Here's your chance to salt this game away if you can just get chunk after chunk after chunk and keep that clock moving.
Tucker with a big play. Now he watches from the sidelines as the Hartley offense goes back to work. And they hand it off. Latham up the middle, dragging players with him as he gets to the 35-yard line.
Again, if you've never seen a Bishop Hartley game, you're thinking, boy, that's not much of a play there. No, that's exactly what they want to do. They want to get 3-4 yards here. It's kind of that Woody Hayes, 3 yards in a cloud of dust. It's all you're trying to do is get 3-4 yards and, an array of pellets off this turf is all you're trying to do now. Run that clock down, get some positive yardage. Keep it at second and manageable, third and manageable. Find a way to salt this game away.
Once again, that interception by Tucker setting all this up for the Hartley Hawks. They'll take their time. 10 seconds on the play clock. Hand it off, Lathan. And he's able to make a move. Couldn't quite get to the 40-yard line. He kept waiting for that opening. And it never got to be the big opening he was hoping for.
No, not at all. But again, still gets 4 yards there, which is impressive because he does keep pushing the guy forward. Little extracurricular at the end, maybe. Didn't let him go as fast as the Hartley Hawk fans wanted. But a nice job there, finding a way to get that positive yardage. and just fighting all the way to the end, getting whatever he can. Now you have third and two. It's exactly what you want if you're Hartley. You have every play at your disposal, inside the tackle, outside the tackle, jet sweep, whatever you think can get you 2 yards. This is what you got to do. And again, that play clock, you're not snapping this ball until it's under 10 seconds easily.
Charlie working our sideline camera down there, getting the nice looks from field level. Here's a handoff. They try to go right up the middle. And they get across the 40, but will be short of the first down marker.
Boy, that's a great job by the Eagles defensive line. Couldn't see exactly who got that first hit on Latham. There's a couple guys there. Let's see who goes low there. That's just a great tackle. Looks like it's
44.
Yeah, 44. That's Peyton Abrams. Really nice job by him. Going low, knocking Ralston backward. And, yeah, that's a great spot by the officials. They're about a half yard short of that first down. And I don't think Brad Burchard has any question what he's doing here. He's going to go for this.
Yeah, you have to. There's under 7 minutes to go here in the fourth quarter. You get this first down, you continue to move. You hand the football back. Big Walnut has been opportunistic
yep.
with their passing offense in the second half. You don't want to give them that chance.
And you trust your offensive line. You trust your running backs. You got some big boys who have really fought. Oh, but that hurts right there.
Dead ball. Ball start on the offense. It'll be fourth down.
Lorette jumped from the tight end position.
Indeed, and that is going to now probably bring in the punter, and it does as he brings out Connor Bjornson. Yeah, that is just what you can't do. And I know Lorette is shaking his head on that one. He's a senior. He doesn't want to see that happen.
So the pressure will go back to the Hartley defense here after the punt. Bjornson gets it away. Oh, this is a good one. Taken at the 30-yard line. See if the Hawks can track him down. He gets up over the 40 and out of bounds near the 46.
Yeah, really nice punt. Almost out-kicked the coverage a little bit because they hadn't had time to get down the field. But regardless, after the punting struggles of the first half, I think you'll take that any day, just getting it down the field and letting your special teams do the work. But, boy, really nice shot by Big Walnut. They bent, but they didn't break. They did what they had to do to get off the field. And, you know, the Hartley mistake allowed them to get fourth and long, and they had to punt the ball. So let's see if that Hartley defense can stand tall once again, or let's see if Big Walnut can get their offense flowing. They keep getting set back by sacks and loss of yardage plays. Got to keep getting positive yards each and every play if they want to win this game.
Near hands it off, and Seaver started to shoot through, but the Hawks picked him up right at the line of scrimmage, held him to a gain of one.
Yeah, nice patience by him, actually, because it seemed like he had nowhere to go, and I think he just kind of waited there until he found something where he could just dive forward for a yard. I mean, look at him, waiting. Oh, look, there's something. But by then, you have Roy Ralston there on his back, and he only gets a yard. But, again, nice shot by the Hawks. They're bottling up all these yards that Seaver would normally get, because he's shown if he gets a gap, he can jet out of there and get 4 or 5 yards or even more than that.
Remember, Neer's coming off that interception he threw on his last throw. And he'll hand it off. They try to go left side. And again, the Hawks have it shut down.
Yeah, that's Stover this time. And again, we called his name early on, thinking he'd be a nice big back to get those tough yards. Him going to the outside, I don't think, is as effective. And you can see with the speed that the Hawks have on the outside, linebacker, defensive line, even those defensive backs, they swarm him quickly, bring him down, no gain. And here we go, 3rd and 9, another huge play. Probably 4 down territory for the Eagles, so don't have to get it all right now. But you got to get something positive, because if not, you're leaving a long way to go for that quarterback.
Again, Neer, he's been under pressure all night. He's been chased out of the pocket. Last drive, he got to sit in the pocket, and he threw the interception.
Yeah, exactly. These defenders are getting very comfortable defending these wide receivers, thinking they aren't going to break away from them. So there's no worry about letting him stay in the pocket.
3rd down and 9. And we've got a whistle. And it looked like there was movement.
Yeah, it was actually Nate Seavers in the slot. Oh.
Oh. So they didn't even get it snapped before the play clock expired.
Yeah, and that's actually surprising considering we are at 4:39 to go. That clock's moving. They need all the time they can get in case they don't get this. Running that play clock down from 40 seconds is not ideal, I would think.
And you got 2 timeouts.
Exactly.
It's a fourth quarter. Call your timeout.
And that's too big a play to fall back from 39 to 3rd and 14. I would have called that timeout there. But maybe, I mean, honestly, between the quarterback and the coach, maybe they all kind of just weren't paying attention to that play clock, which is widely seen in the play, in the end zone.
It's down to three again. Take the snap. And here's the throw down the middle of the field. It is too far beyond the intended receiver.
Yeah, and I think that's what Hartley, I think, has figured out. They're okay to let to challenge him throwing the ball deep. They did have the receiver behind the defender, but at the same time, that's got to be an accurate throw. And so far, near the show, he can accurately throw it that far downfield. So, once again, nice job by Hartley. Just enough pressure to force him to not be able to step into an accurate throw. And really nice defending on the back end by Fidelis Ajoma to make sure that receiver really didn't have a clean look at that catch.
So the Hawks going to receive a punt now. Oh, what a seesaw match this is between these two teams. There's pressure. Oh, this kick is straight up the elevator shaft. And it bounces, and it takes a big walnut bounce. And it'll get inside the 40, down to the 36, 37. Boy, that could have been much worse.
Oh, absolutely. That ball could have bounced at midfield and gone the other direction. So for it to go the way it did, Big Walnut actually very, very lucky. Just didn't catch that on the toe as he wanted to. Caught it more in the ankle area, straight up in the air. Hardly benefits by getting a shorter punt than maybe could have been. But at the same time, Big Walnut gets a big bounce. And with 4:20 to go here, oh, buddy, this is the ball game. If Hartley can really hold on to this ball and get some first downs.
This is set up for the Bishop Hartley offense. Correct. Right here. As you just said, 4 minutes and 20 seconds. You need a couple of first downs.
It was 4 minutes and 20 seconds in the second quarter, and they gave the ball back to Big Walnut. So let's see if they can do it differently this
here
time.
Here they come. Jet sweep. And to the near sideline and being brought down inbounds, Ryan Perry.
Yeah, Aiden West doing what every defender would do in this situation. Watch him go for the strip here instead of the tackle. All right, they're reaching for that ball. Got to put that away, Ryan. Just got to be safe. Don't want to fumble the ball right there. But nice job. Held onto the ball. Got good yardage. And the Hawks set up here in second and short.
And they will take their time because they have it.
Yeah, and you can't see it here. There are play clocks on each end on the end zones here. So every player knows when they are going to likely snap it, when, you know, Gallic should snap it. And he's going inside 5 seconds here.
And he does snap, and he pitches it back to Lathan. And Lathan, good cut. He's got the first down. He's got more inside the 45 to the 43.
Yeah, this is where you can start to smell blood in the water, and Lathan feels it, man. Not just a cutback, but putting his head down and driving forward for each and every yard. Great block, and nice job there by Jay Sang. Little up the field by Morville's offensive lineman, and then Lathan's legs keep moving. The Eagles are just dragging on him. Nicely done. That's about a 20-yard gain, and the clock just keeps moving. Eagles know they only have two timeouts, and they've got to stop them on this set of downs here.
And there you see it, down to 3:05 remaining. 21-19, two-point lead for the Hawks. Sophomore quarterback, Gallich running this offense. Offset eye behind him, hands it to the up man. And he will take it straight through. And get himself inside the 40, down to the 39.
Yep, Jay Zhang with the quick carry right there. Just fullback dive, nothing wrong with that.
And I'll tell you what I like here too, Matt. You were talking about the offense isn't going to snap the ball until there were 5 seconds or less on that clock. The defense knows that. Mm-hmm. So you can anticipate a little bit, right?
Yeah,
when he gets to five, get up on your toes because you know it's coming.
100%, exactly.
And they're still able to pick up. They're getting chunks. Even if it's a three-yard chunk, they're getting it.
And that says a lot about the drive that the Hartley offensive line is having right now. They have been pushing this pile at the line of scrimmage for a while now. And even here, when they can anticipate the snap, they're still not getting enough jump on them.
There he goes, under center. Thunder 5 takes it. Lathan, nice cut again, and he's inside the 35, down to the 30. It's a first down for the Hartley Hawks.
You know, that's one of the staples of this Hartley offense, that as a fan makes your heart jump a little, those little short pitches, because, boy, if that catch doesn't happen right there, that's a fumble and you're worried. But Lathan secures the ball, and then, again, because of that pitch, he's allowed some forward momentum, and that allows him to keep driving that pile. Another first down inside 2 minutes. I think Big Walnut knows, they're absolutely up against it right now. Now for the Big Walnut defense, you're stripping, you're pulling, you're doing everything you can, get that ball loose, because if not, Hartley's going to run this clock out.
Say, Lathan, his patience in running the football is very impressive.
Yeah, it is. I mean, he he's very aware that his O-line's doing good enough work. He doesn't need to go fast. He can go at a good pace and allow them to do the work that he can then just run behind them and then push the pile once he hits contact.
Well, Big Walnut doesn't take a timeout. Hartley, they got it down. They were lining up. They were going to snap it, looked like, but you know what? You play it safe.
Yep.
You take the timeout. You don't take the 5 yards here because that could give momentum back the other way.
Absolutely. Yeah, I mean, look where you are on the field, too. Remember this. You're already on the other side of the 40 here. Even if you give the ball back here and Big Walnut uses their two timeouts, you're not leaving them a lot of time to get all the way down the field for a field goal. So use up as much of the clock as you can here. Each one of these plays, hopefully they take 5-6 seconds. Grind it out. Get every yard you can. Stay up on your feet. Whatever it takes to hopefully get that final first down. First down wins the game now. So that's all you're looking for. But if you don't get it, find a way to extend these plays and really, really, yeah, you're going to use all four downs. Really use up all the clock you can.
It's the Big Walnut defense that is being put to the test.
Yeah. They've got to be gassed.
They've been out there all night.
Absolutely. I mean, they've been getting pushed and pulled and just run over by these O-linemen and the running backs like Lathan. They've got to be tired.
Little offset eye formation here with a minute 21 to play in the fourth quarter. Hand it off to the first man. And, oh, there's what you're talking about, Matt. Stay on your feet. Yep. 5-6 seconds until the whistle comes.
Yeah, tick, 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 right? And now Big Walnut does call their first time, or excuse me, their second timeout.
Good job by Jay Zhang right here. Watch him. I've got a little bit of a spot. Now I'm just going to stay standing.
Yep. And you see the rest of the Hartley teammates find a way to push one way, the Big Walnut team pushing the other way. But obviously, if he's staying up on his feet and making any kind of positive yardage, they will keep him moving.
Again, Zhang is sophomore.
Sophomore.
And getting a lot of responsibility late in a two-point game, and that really says a lot. That gives confidence to the player, but if the coaches don't have that belief in you coming out of camp, you're not getting this kind of an opportunity.
100%. I mean, you have some seniors on this in this backfield that you think would get the ball first here, but the fact that you feel comfortable giving it to Zhang, giving it to Rawson, giving it to Latham, giving it to Shoemate. You know, we've seen Wooten get the ball, Perry get the ball in the jet sweep. So many weapons. Winbush. It's a hard team to scout against when you don't know who's going to get the ball at any time. Man in motion, if they're going to pitch it, give it, fake it. It's tough right now. That's why I understand why a lot of these defenses and defensive coaches can't sleep at night planning for the Hawks.
Second down and 6. Latham trying to be patient again, but this time they're going to catch him from behind after a gain of only 2.
And again, hold on to that ball, and that's what he did. I think in that case, he prioritized holding on to the ball more than pushing forward, understanding that ball security is paramount in this situation.
So the final timeout taken by Big Walnut. Yeah, here's what you're talking about. Protect the football.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
Robert Lathan making sure that it's in his possession.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, again, kudos to Big Walnut. You can see Eli Helton in there, Justin Netling in there, trying to strip it out. Not going to happen. And so now if you're a Big Walnut, Coach Curtis Craig, you're just thinking, all right, what do we need to do here? How much time are we going to have left? It's a 40-second play clock after this play. Minute 8. You're down to 28 just with that alone. The play is going to probably take 6 seconds. You're down to 22 seconds. In other words, the math is not mathing very well. So you need a turnover badly. You are asking for these guys to really pull hard at that, just strip that ball. Because if not, it's going to take quite the miracle to pull this off.
I was just impressed with your math.
Oh, thank you. Listen, the last math class I took was here at Bishop Hartley, so it says a lot. It still stands with me.
Third down. And it's about 4, just under 5.
And again, if you're Hartley, getting the first down isn't as huge a deal anymore. It's keeping the ball in your possession.
Going to send Zhang in motion to pitch it and getting inside the 25 to the 24.
Oh, boy. Now, a couple things I didn't like here. One, the pitch.
I figured that was number one, by the way.
That was number one. But two, the helmet actually falling off hurts them. That play clock would have been at 40 seconds and run. Now because they have to stop the clock for the helmet coming off, it goes to 25, and they actually lose 15 seconds there. Now the clock is running now, but they lost 15 seconds because that helmet came off. Which
so
is
all that math you did just got messed up right
up.
There. Right there.
But here's the quick math I can do. Hartley's going to call a timeout, and there's going to be about 37 seconds left, and it'll be 4th and short. So Big Walnut at the end, even if they do get the ball back, it's going to be 30 seconds or less.
Well, there you go. 37 and a half seconds.
We have a timeout. Hartley, their second timeout.
Well, as you said before, first down wins the game. It's fourth down and four. If you can get those 4 yards, you're going to win. If you don't get those 4 yards, your defense is going to be called on once again to try to stop what one would think would be a long pass or a couple of medium passes.
Correct, yeah. And, you know, and the problem is we've seen in high school football before, a medium pass turns into a touchdown. Yeah. A medium, small, short screen pass turns into a long gain. And with the kicker they have only down 2 points, they don't even have to get all the way to the end zone. Only have to get maybe to 25-yard line and leave yourself a, you know, a 40-some-yard field goal. So ideally get the first down here.
Yeah, you're right. That's the key, actually, mm-hmm. having that weapon, having that field goal kicker. That really complicates all of this.
It does, because the clock's going to stop on a first down. So even if they get down on the ground after a 15, 20-yard gain, that's plenty of time to get up and spike the ball. Or in, you know, in the case where maybe they just get pushed out, you know, before the end zone, they're not out of this by any means. So getting this first down would be huge. If not, just hold on to the ball again. Don't allow anything that allows them to get more yards the other way.
They stay with Zhang and Latham in the backfield. Bring Wooten up. Long snap count. And again, they have time to do all of this. And now that Hartley's had a chance to look at what Big Walnut is showing, they'll take their final timeout.
Yeah, I think you're trying to get your cheap offside, jump offside there, and maybe win the game on a penalty instead. Didn't work. Good discipline by Big Walnut there, not jumping offside. I think they knew as well that Hartley may do that. But now, no more timeouts left, so it all comes down to this. There will be a play here. Smart by Hartley here. Do not jump at all and false start. Don't make this hard on yourself on 4th and 9. And then if you're a Big Walnut, you definitely can't jump as well because you're going to end the game like that.
I want to see where they line up Perry this time because they had him right on the line, so he couldn't go in motion for that jet sweep. Will they line him up on the outside again? Will they give themselves that option? Looks like they're going to line him up on the outside.
Yep, so that means if you're going to the left side, he'll be a blocker. If they go to the right, where there's plenty of room, but again, not a blocker in front. See what they do here.
Now they do bring it back toward the formation. Make it much tighter and hand it off. And here's Latham. Picks his way to the throw. 20, 15, 10, and he's down at the 1 yard line.
Listen, that is what you call a smart football player right there. We have seen that play before where you fall into the end zone. Why is that important? Yes, they go up by 8 points, but if that extra point's no good, what happens? Big Walnut gets a chance to go down the field with 20-some seconds, and who knows what happened. Taking a knee, that clock's going to run, and it should have been running before this. They're going to have to stop this because the play clock's below the game clock, but this game's over.
The Bishop Hartley Hawks, opening week, victorious on their home field, stunning the Big Walnut Eagles, who were slow to get going, and then they cranked it up, but it turns out to be too little, too late, as the Hawks get the win.
Yeah, what a performance by both these teams, frankly. What a great game for week one. Both teams trading punches in the second half, and then in the fourth quarter, when there was such an offensive explosion in the third quarter, neither team could score. Just a fantastic ball game. Both these teams are due to have great seasons, I think. Both their offense and defense is going to get better from this game, but what a fantastic ball game.
We saw the jitters early on. The first drive, the first offensive drive for both teams was like,
not good. A lot of laundry.
What did you guys do in camp?
Right.
And the coaches are probably wondering, what did we teach them in camp?
Exactly.
This was not it.
Yeah.
But they both settled down, as you said. What a heck of a football game in opening week. A 2-point game, 21-19. Look, they should be proud on both sides. But the Bishop Hartley Hawks, in some ways undersized. They're certainly undermanned. Mm-hmm. But the heart was bigger here tonight. They just went out and played their game.
This is a bit of a response game, too, from last year, right? I mean, this was a team that went to Sunbury last year, lost 35-7. It was a bit of an embarrassment, and it led to a tough year. You can get a lot of momentum off a win like this. It's a Division II team that won 10 games last year, went to a regional semifinals, and you just beat them on your home field. And you felt like you were in control of the game for most of it, too. That's a heck of a win. Going into a big game at Bloom Carroll next week, that's another good quality team. If you're Hartley, you're feeling really good after this game.
No doubt about it. And You know, it was the defense that kind of led the way, kind of set the tone, but then the offense very quickly followed here tonight.
100%. I think the defense was absolutely the star of the game here. Not only did the offense score 21, I'm sorry, the defense scored 7 of the 21
that's
points,
right.
I should say. That's how good they were, and they really kind of carried the load most of the way here. They were just fantastic. Denham Cook was in the backfield a lot. Donovan Davis stuffed up a lot. Ralston and Zhang, and then the defensive backs really kind of held court in the second half there when the passing game really started to go. Neer had nowhere to throw the ball, and that was huge. I mean, he wanted to throw the ball, and he just couldn't find anyone open. That's the credit to the defensive backfield.
Couldn't find anybody open and didn't have a lot of time. No. That was the key. The Hartley defense, the defensive line, the linebackers, great job with pressure on that quarterback tonight. And then later in the game, when they gave him all the time in the world, they didn't give him, as you said, anybody to throw to.
Nowhere to throw it to, yeah. So great job by that Hartley defense. That was shaken a little bit after that third quarter, giving up 10 points. The Big Walnut offense was really starting to move the ball. Seavers was getting his legs, finding those gaps. They really kind of bowed up there. And then kudos to the offense when they needed to finish the game off. They did just that. Needed to get those late first downs. They chugged away, found a way. Latham, what a game he had. My goodness, he was just chugging the entire game. I'd give him the rock anytime the way he was playing today. I don't know if he got over 100 yards, but it sure felt like it the way he was just racking up the yards in the second half.
Yeah, when they needed somebody at the end to just put it away. He was that somebody at the end that put it away. Let's take a look at the big plays of the game. This is the first score. It's for Big Walnut. A mishandled punt. They get this in the end zone, they think. Then it gets away. This turns into a safety.
You want to talk about big plays of the game. This could have been the difference between a win or a loss, right? If they fall on that ball, that's a touchdown. Instead, it's a safety. Only 2 points, not six. And that's massive when you look at the final score, obviously.
Joey Wooten with a big play there to make sure it was just a safety. Now here goes Latham. He's into the end zone for the first Hartley touchdown. This is where they really started to get things going.
Yeah, absolutely. That's when the offense really started to move, and they were just in control, it seemed like. And then the defense coming up big. Brendan Lorette with the pick. But that's got the Denham Cooks pressure. Again, the pressure was giving Neer all kind of problems, and that's the ultimate pressure there when it turns into a pick six.
Hartley was feeling pretty good about themselves. They had a 14-2 lead, and then all of a sudden, it was Big Walnut coming back, took advantage of a 15-yard penalty, and got this touchdown late in the first half.
This all about a 1 minute and 5 second drive, too, all in the last 2 minutes. Fantastic job by them to make it 14-9 at the half.
Then they got the big 40-yard field goal right there, and they had themselves back to within two. But then Hartley went right back to work. Rory Ralston. That's veteran leadership right there.
Indeed, yeah, and that was a great drive by Hawks. So the long run by Latham that set it all up. But again, Big Walnut had a chance. They made it 21-19, but this pick is huge for them. Again, not even the pressure this time. It was just not having anyone to throw to. Great interception by Donovan Tucker, and that all but pretty much gave Hartley the defensive play they needed to put this game away.
And then it's Latham again at the end. And watch this. Here's a heads-up play. Touchdown. No, we don't need that. Kneeling at the one-yard line. We'll run the clock out and go home with the W.
Such a heads-up play, I tell you. I think, and I'm sure they told him to do that, but it's hard to tell a high school kid not to score a touchdown, right? I mean, to take a knee at the half-yard line, impressive stuff. An impressive victory in week one for this team. It shows a lot of guts. And to be able to take the punch that they did on this home field against a very good squad, really good opening night win.
Really good. Everybody involved in it. When Hartley plays their best, it is a team effort, and it certainly was here tonight.
Absolutely. Offense, defense, special teams. It was nice to see Connor Bjornson relax a little. He had some good punts down the stretch. Yep. Those are big for them. So it was nice to see them slowly grow into themselves. Big week two matchup ahead, but for now, celebrate week one.
Absolutely. Enjoy the night. If you're a Hartley Hawk, that's what these guys are going to do as they get a huge victory at home in week one over Big Walnut. Final score, the Hartley Hawks 21, the Eagles of Big Walnut 19. For Matt Barnes, I'm Bob McElligott saying so long, and thanks for watching Bishop Hartley Football.
Today's broadcast is presented by Columbus Painting Company. Call us for a free estimate at 614-818-8028 or visit cbuspaintingcompany.com. By the Mortgage Captain. Need guidance on your home buying journey? Call Todd Utrip at 614-618-3331. By Yamo Media. Be on the lookout for the new Yamo Media app, soon to be available on the Android and Apple Store, as well as yamomedia.com. By Training ABC. Employee training courses that are simply better. Visit trainingabc.com for more information. And by PageTech. Take your event to the next level with Page Tech Limited. Visit us at PageTechLTD.com for more information.